800-874-9760. Reuters reports the head of the U.S. Secret Service faced scathing criticism on Tuesday for the agency allowing an intruder with a knife to run into the White House, while details emerged of a separate security lapse involving an armed contractor who rode an elevator with President Barack Obama. Secret Service Director Julia Pearson acknowledged the agency charged with protecting Obama had failed on September 19th when it allowed a man to jump the fence at the home of the president, burst through the front door, and run about 130 feet into the East Room, which is used for events and receptions. Pearson told a U.S. House of Representatives committee, "This is unacceptable, and I take full responsibility." As a first step, Pearson said that the front door of the White House now has an automated lock when there is a security breach. It did not have one at the time of the intrusion. Pearson said that any disciplinary actions, however, would be based on an internal probe by the agency. In the spirit of Motorhome Diaries and Liberty on Tour, I intend to take the message of peace, love, and liberty on the road. During the 104-day trip, I'll be visiting at least 10 cities across the country, speaking to people about the ideas of peace, love, and liberty. To find out more about the tour or to donate, visit tour.fppradio.com. That's tour.fppradio.com. The Associated Press reports Oklahoma prison officials unveiled new execution procedures Tuesday to replace those used in April when an inmate writhed and moaned before being declared dead 43 minutes after his lethal injection began, a situation that renewed debate over what constitutes cruel and unusual punishment. The new guidelines allow the state to keep using midazolam, a sedative used in flawed executions earlier this year in Ohio, Oklahoma, and Arizona, although it calls for increasing by 5 times the dose it gave Clayton Lockett in April. Other changes include more training requirements for prison staff and members of the execution team, and having contingency plans in case the problem with execution equipment or an inmate's medical condition. The new protocols also reduce the number of media witnesses from 12 to 5. An investigation ordered by Governor Mary Fallon after Lockett's execution that was conducted by the Department of Public Safety blamed his lengthy death on the poor placement of a single intravenous line in his groin and a decision by the warden to cover the IV site with a sheet. The investigation recommended more training for prison staff and a contingency plan, both of which are included in the new procedures. Assistant Public Defender Dale Beach, who represents 21 death row inmates who have sued the State Department of Corrections to block their executions, said the new protocols do not solve Oklahoma's execution problems. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
According to a report released this week, people who paint themselves silver and pretend to be statues earn, on average, $10 million per year. The Onion sat down with economist Mark Cosgrave to learn more about the money-making potential of this highly lucrative employment path.
There's no more profitable career at the moment. If you compare these positions to other high-paying jobs, say physicians or mechanical engineers, you'll find that those individuals who have outfitted themselves with silver-painted boxes and can move their limbs stiffly as if they were a robot are making literally hundreds of times as much. At this point, I would say that the only job that offers anywhere near that kind of earning potential is dressing up like Batman and allowing people to pose for photos with you. And those guys who play paint buckets like drums have historically done well for themselves. But honestly, the recession hit these professions pretty hard, and a lot of them are only making something like $800,000 a year at this point. It's barely even worth their time.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can take control of the airwaves here toll-free, 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio tonight, it's Ian here. Cantwell.
And Mark.
And you join us online over at freetalklive.com, where there's all kinds of features created by listeners like you. You can, the content, actually, the main content created by listeners like you over at freetalklive.com, you get to submit what you want right there to the front page of the website. So it's a Reddit-based system, which means it's free. You can log in with your Reddit account and your Freetalk Live account and then essentially link the two accounts together in a very, very quick process. The top story over there right now is City says no cameras, this man defies them. Sounds right up my alley. So go and check that out at freetalklive.com. Last night, to bring you up to speed, if you're just tuning in, and Cantwell, since you weren't here, the ISIS videos, not the beheading videos. We've talked about those in the past. There's a new series of videos coming out from the people claiming to be ISIS. And we don't know who's making them, really. Maybe it's the CIA. I don't know. But I think the content's very interesting. They have one of their prisoners, John Cantley. He is, and it's actually spelled Cantlie, C-A-N-T-L-I-E, which is an interesting name for someone who's reading propaganda, because that's essentially what he does. He sits there. He's at a table. There's a black background. He's
chopping down cherry trees.
No, he just sits there at the table. Oh, that's a Lincoln joke. So he's
pretty sure that's Washington.
Oh, Lincoln didn't chop down the cherry tree? I thought Lincoln chopped down some kind of cherry.
No, it was George Washington, and he didn't actually do it. It was completely made up. It's just a story where it's like, Father, I cannot tell a lie.
It sold some books. You know, so I graduated from the dumb school in my county, which is the county north of Ian's County. We grew up in the same area. And, you know, I went to the adult school program for the bad kids. Mm-hmm. Ian spent the whole time, his whole public school career at the genius school. He doesn't know anything. He knows nothing.
Wasn't there some kind of thing about Abraham Lincoln about that?
No.
This is entirely a George Washington fable. And I mean, I was, you know, in honors classes at one point, and then I was like, screw this, and, you know, stopped going to school and got kicked out, or I dropped out, actually, but... And I know this story. So
smart move.
Thank you, public schooling.
He just sits there at a table and talks.
Pretty sure I got that from Schoolhouse Rock or something.
Directly into
I think I learned more from Schoolhouse Rock than I did from 13 years of education.
So John Cantley is the spokesman now for ISIS. He sits and delivers a pre-written message from a teleprompter directly into a camera. There's a black background. He's sitting there with his orange prisoner shirt on, and that's the content of these videos. We played the first of those videos. Actually, technically, there have been three so far. The first one was just like an introduction where he talks about himself a little bit and, you know, why it is that he's doing this, that he's been abandoned by the United Kingdom government. He's a former photojournalist who was abducted somewhere, I forget where, in the Middle East, but he's been in custody of ISIS allegedly since 2012. And so the first one was just like an intro video saying, hey, we're going to put out this series of videos. And the series has begun. They're now up to video 2 and 3. We played video 2 last night, the audio track of it. And I have the third video here tonight, which just came out a couple of days ago. It's called, the series is called Lend Me Your Ears. And we don't know how many videos will be coming out with this guy hosting them. And I think they're interesting because they give you another perspective. Now, you know, there's three sides to every story, side A, side B, and then there's the truth. So I don't know what the truth is. I'm not claiming that this is the truth, but it's somebody else's perspective on things that's not the mainstream media in America, that's not the government of the United States or the United Kingdom. And so from that perspective, it's interesting to hear what John Cantley has to say.
Now, are we under the impression that these are John Cantley's words and thoughts, or that he's reading these?
He's definitely reading a script.
But okay. Did you hear the sort of colloquial intonations that went into his speech that we listened to last night?
Give me an example of that.
I can't give you an example because I listened to it last night and I didn't listen to it a moment ago. But the way it was written by an English speaker. It was written by somebody who speaks English very,
very well. Yep.
Not, I mean, because the acid test of any language is to be able to understand colloquial expressions and apply them properly. I mean, you know, if you can do that, you can do crosswords, you're fluent. It's a language you're facile with. I kind of feel like he was editing at the very least.
You mean Cantley was editing? You think Cantley was editing the copy that he was reading?
I think so.
Either that, it's possible. You know, I think the James Foley video that they had put out was put out, you know, the guy speaking on it was a guy with a British accent.
Yes.
You know, he was the one who was allegedly doing the beheading. So, I mean, apparently, you know, it would seem if these things are what we're told that they are, then it would appear that they have some native English speakers amongst them.
It's not uncommon, you know, to find English as a relatively well-spoken language around the world. I'm not surprised by that.
Yeah, the guy that, this native speaker of English, just because you can speak English and just because you have an English accent doesn't mean that you can apply colloquial terms that well. These tend to be regional. They tend to, they tend to exclude people. This guy, from the looks of him, grew up in a family of Middle Easterners that was living in London.
This guy, meaning
the guy we're talking
John
about,
John Cantley?
No, not John Cantley.
The alleged beheader.
The alleged beheader looked like
Jihadi John or whatever they're calling him.
Okay, Jihadi
like
John looked like a guy that grew up in a house of people, you know, that were from the Middle East that had moved to London for some period of time. Yeah, he had an English accent, but he still. I don't know. I mean, is he going to be able to do this? I was just impressed by the script and its ease with the language.
Okay. That under consideration, we're going to play for you the second of the series of actual propaganda videos, allegedly from ISIS, hosted by John Cantley, and we'll begin that now. We'll comment and pause throughout this. I know you're welcome to comment with your thoughts as well at 855-450-FREE. Again, this one just released about 2 or 3 days ago at this point.
Hello, I'm John Cantley, the British citizen abandoned by my government and a long-term prisoner of the Islamic State. President Obama's address on the 13th anniversary of the 9/11 attacks finally stopped all the ninnying around and laid down his four-stage strategy for confronting the Islamic State. There were no big surprises. US aircraft will provide the air power, while a mix of Iraqi army, Iraqi National Guard, not yet formed, Peshmerga fighters and Iranians, not mentioned, will do the ground operations. The border between Iraq...
That's interesting.
Do you hear the way he says this? You know, these Peshmerga fighters, not mentioned.
Ninnying around, I heard him say, it sounded like.
He adds it on to the end of the sentence in a way that somebody who writes would do. This isn't...
It's well written. There's no doubt about it. I don't think that means John Cantley was the one doing the writing. I mean, that's a jump to a conclusion.
They have a journalist on site, and you don't think it was the journalist doing the well-written writing?
Well, they haven't cut his head off yet, so maybe he is adding some value to the
operation. I mean, do we know anything about John Cantley's politics before he winds up in this place? I mean, maybe he's a genuinely anti-war guy who's like, yeah, this is ridiculous, and now I'm going to die because of it. I mean, that potential exists.
That's what I'm kind of thinking. To some extent, these people, you know, they're experiencing Stockholm Syndrome. That's why I wonder about all these videos. This is a fantasy. This is a conspiracy theory. Mm-hmm. But let's say for a second, both of the three of these guys that have had their heads cut off are like, hey, look, we can cut your head off or you can play along with us. Which would you want to do? And they're like, I'll play along.
I don't know about somebody who's being coerced into writing something, producing something worth, like, I don't know that somebody's coerced into writing something is writing something well written. I can't imagine that somebody puts a gun to my head and tells me to write an article and I come out with something fantastic. Yeah. I can't picture that.
Yeah, you'd almost try to do badly.
Yeah.
Well, what I thought was interesting was the, I didn't watch Obama's speech, but he's saying that they're going to be using Iranian troops, which is interesting.
Yeah, it's the first time hearing of that, and I did watch the speech, so.
Yeah, well, as he's saying, Obama didn't mention that.
Yeah.
They're the ones who are informing us of that, making that claim, which of course would be ironic considering that Iran was supposed to be the axis of evil, right? Well, now apparently the axis of evil is completely okay if you're going to team up with them to go after ISIS. There's more coming up at 855. 450-FREE. We'll continue.
Are you living with pain? I was, after a nasty fall. I got relief with 1 hour pain relief. I'm Barry Yarconi, president, and here's Lisa, a Marine who was injured in Iraq.
After surviving an explosion, I was on horrible painkillers for lingering head, shoulder, back, and knee pain. But I hated the dangers and side effects. My friend told me about 1 hour pain relief, and now I'm off the drugs.
1 hour pain relief is the result of 15 years of research on an amazing extract from hops, the plant used to flavor beer.
Whether your pain is from an injury or just aging, you get safe, all-day relief in less than 1 hour.
Get a free one-week trial for just the small shipping charge. Call 800-900-1221 right now, or visit onehourpainrelief.com. There's no gimmicks, no obligation, no automatic shipments. Stop living with pain. Call 800-900-1221 or visit onehourpainrelief.com. That's 800-900-1221 or onehourpainrelief.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw for the enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power, a gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
The amount of young people being brought up on criminal charges, sex offender charges, for taking nude photos of themselves and putting them online. It's just so sad to see these people having their lives just rolled right over the top of by these prosecutors that want to make it look like they're doing something good, but they're not doing anything that's helping anyone. There's no victim in this case. When you hear the term child pornography, what should come to mind, if anything, should be the idea of forcing children into sexual scenes and videotaping or photographing
adults
them.
Forcing children or somebody.
Even if it's a child forcing another child, it's, I think the force is the issue there. If you're talking about a 15-year-old girl voluntarily choosing to take a nude photo of herself to send to her boyfriend or to post online, no one forced her to do that.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, Mark will tell us about the Syrian airstrikes. Apparently, they have now been exempted from what were allegedly tight standards on killing innocent civilians. I didn't know they had any such standards to begin with, but now they don't apply. We'll get the details on that. Your calls and thoughts are welcome as well at 855-450-FREE. We are playing for you video footage. You get the audio, obviously, of John Cantley, the hostage from the UK, allegedly being kept by the folks from ISIS. He is reading propaganda into a video camera, and I think it's interesting stuff because it gives you the other side of the story. And you don't typically find that within American mainstream media. In fact, it's very hard to find these videos within the mainstream media. They are reporting on these videos, but they don't ever actually link you to them. So it took me some effort to try to find this video. It's not an easy thing to do, so it's actually somewhat rare. We'll get into more of that here in a moment.
You can go to coffee.freetalklive.com and get a free pound of the best coffee. It's BuzzBox. It's shade-grown, 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica beans. Coffee is a very absorbent crop, so that makes organic certification in that case that much more important. BuzzBox is competitively priced with other high-end coffees, but they do something that other coffee producers don't seem to care anything about. They set up a program that allows people around the world to buy into their co-ops. And Free Talk Live's attempting to recruit, 1,000 listeners here to order their coffee from coffee.freetalklive.com. This will allow us to finance 100 microloans through Kiva. So help us change lives by offering people in poverty an opportunity to change their own lives. Get started now by getting your free pound of coffee at coffee.freetalklive.com. Now, you're going to have to pay the shipping for the pound. You can cancel that subscription at any time. It's coffee.freetalklive.com.
Just to be clear, we don't have to get to 1,000 listeners. I mean, that's a nice goal to
have. That's the goal.
But for every 10 listeners, we can issue a new microloan, correct?
Yep. Actually, yeah. I mean, we can do it. Yes, that's true.
Right. So we're not waiting until we reach 1,000. We're already issuing microloans out to folks via Kiva.
True statement.
Okay. Good to know. 855-450-FREE. Go grab your free pound over at coffee.freetalklive.com. More with John Cantley. He is, it's another about 5.5 minute video here. We're about a minute into it thus far. He's talking about Barack Obama's statement a couple of weeks ago about how he's so tough and he's going to go and, you know, stop ISIS, what his plan was. And so ISIS here, or the folks claiming to be ISIS, are releasing a series of videos giving their side of the story through one of their prisoners, John Cantley, a former photojournalist from the UK, as he continues his narration.
Peshmerga fighters and Iranians, not mentioned, will do the ground operations. The border between Iraq and Syria will be open and Syrian rebels will be armed. And all of this with only 475 extra U.S. advisory personnel doing the job. And not a single U.S. combat soldier with his boot on the ground. We will lead a broad coalition to roll back the Islamic State, said Obama. We're hitting ground targets while Iraqi forces go on the offense. I will not hesitate to take action against the Islamic State in Syria, he said. Now, when exactly Gulf War III will start and how long it will take isn't covered. U.S. advisors working with the Iraqi army have described their performance as consistently grim. While arming and training an effective National Guard of supposed Sunni fighters in western Iraq will take months to achieve. The Free Syrian Army are proven to be an undisciplined, corrupt...
Wait a second. Did he say arming Sunni fighters in western Iraq?
I can jump it back. I think he might have.
Why would Sunnis be fighting the Islamic State?
Aren't they Shiite? Is that
no, the... they're Sunni. I'm certain of that.
Let me jump it back here. Hang on.
...in western Iraq will take months. Describe their performance as consistently grim. While arming and training an effective National Guard of supposed Sunni fighters in western Iraq will take months to achieve.
Okay.
The Free Syrian Army are proven to be an undisciplined, corrupt, and largely ineffective fighting force. As recently as September the 7th, a senior U.S. intelligence official said, our intelligence assessment has no serious consideration to work with the FSA. Giving the FSA $500 million now is a completely pointless exercise, never mind the fact that the FSA sells the weapons the West gives them to arms dealers and smugglers.
Wah, wah, wah. Is anybody surprised by that one?
No, not in the slightest bit.
No.
And I just Googled it, and apparently the Islamic State is a Sunni thing, so I guess they're trying to train Sunnis to fight Sunnis.
Right. So they're going
to make it not as like sectarian is the idea.
They're going to take a vilified underclass, the Sunni, in Iraq, because Iraq is a Shiite. you know, the United States came in, turned it from Sunni to Shiite, and they're going to take this vilified underclass, and they're going to say, come on, guys, fight with us against your people who believe like you.
Hmm. He did say supposedly Sunni.
He did say that.
Continue.
And much of it then ends up with the Islamic State.
And this is the thing, like we've seen, they were talking about this, and I think I said it on the show, when they were talking about arming moderate Syrian rebels, you know, and I'm like, tell me more about these moderates who are violently overthrowing their government. And yes, this is ISIS is partly born out of these factions that were fighting the Syrian government. And we've already seen them with like rocket launchers made in America that were shipped to them by the U.S. government.
Well, the Shiites dropped their stuff and ran away. Now the United States is bombing its own Humvees that are being driven by Sunnis.
And I was looking for a video that Adam had played on his show, Adam Kokesh, that there was a video, it was like a half hour long of this guy just like showing you around ISIS, you know, and he's like, yeah, it was like a tour, you know, he's like, here we are at the Syrian-Iraq border, and he's just walking back and forth, and at one point he says to the camera, he's like, Obama, please send more corporate U.S. money, like he was just showing like all this American equipment that they had, and he thought it was so great, and he's like, yes, please send more of it, we really appreciate it.
Continuing on here.
The power is good at taking out specific targets, but it is not much use at taking and holding ground. For that, you need effective, disciplined troops. And it's hard to see how this hodgepodge army, with a long history of underperforming, is going to be any form of credible infantry. After the speech, Peter Baker of the New York Times observed that Obama is plunging the United States into one of the bloodiest, most vicious conflicts now in existence. He will pass his successor a volatile and incomplete war, much as his predecessor left one for him. Mr. Baker goes on to comment that while previous presidents enjoyed a surge of public support when they took the nation to war, the public is not rallying behind Obama this time around. Polls indicate that while the American public support military action against Islamic State, they do not think that Obama is the man for the job. Which goes a long way.
Which isn't going to do really great for whoever the Democrat nominee is, Mrs. Clinton.
That's speculative, but we'll find out more.
Don't think it's going to do well for whoever ends up in that seat, because then they'll just be like, "Hey, I inherited this mess," just
they
like
don't
Obama
care
said
once they get the seat, though.
First at the beginning of his first and second term, like, "Hey, I inherited this mess,
so let's make more of a mess."
Yeah. Americans haven't voted out a president in office without a third party candidate screwing things up since Carter.
We'll come back with the remainder of the video here from ISIS. You know. You got to hand it to them. They're making some good points here. More on the way. 855.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
450 free. This is Free Talk Live.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro-Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at herbalhealer.com. As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988. Herbal Healer Academy.
Who did you let down today? Your wife? Your kids? Well, how about yourself? Take a look in the mirror. If you're tired of your drug and alcohol problem, you need to fix the problem and right now, before you hurt or kill yourself, or worse yet, somebody else. Call the addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have private insurance, we specialize in finding you the right treatment. When you call right now, you'll speak to a recovering addict who understands what you're going through right now. Let us help you break your addiction to drug and alcohol before it's too late. This call is completely confidential and free. So if you have private insurance, take 5 minutes of your time, call right now. I promise it'll change your life. 800-208-5187, 800-208-5187, 800-208-5187. Call right now, 800-208-5187.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace Love Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free, bring up anything you want, 855-450-FREE. We're talking about the ISIS propaganda videos, a series called Lend Me Your Ears, hosted by one of their alleged prisoners, John Cantley, from the UK, former photojournalist. He hasn't been doing much photojournalism because he's been in custody since 2012 when he was allegedly abducted. Now he is the host of a series of videos, which we don't know how long the series will last for, and we also don't know whether or not his services will spare him from having his head cut off in the final video, because
compensation may well be a brutal beheading video.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's a horror. Of course, these beheading videos are horrible, and that's a whole other topic of discussion. But this is interesting because it's the other side of the story. It's not hard to get the U.S. government's perspective on ISIS.
It's hard not to.
Yeah. I mean, the mainstream media is putting that out there all over the place. These videos, however, are relatively difficult to come by. Last night, and it's actually interesting watching this this version. It's being hosted by the Clarion Project, which doesn't seem to be... I don't know. I don't know much about them, but they say as addressing Islamic extremism is their tagline. That's all I know about them. They are the ones who put this up on their YouTube channel. And unlike the one that we played last night, the pictures in this one are not being blurred out. The initial video of propaganda, the only versions I could find online had all the photos that were used in the video to illustrate. They were blurred out. This one, that's not happening with. I suspect that it's because if they don't blur the videos, that YouTube can take down the videos because of copyright violations. So I was never able to. I looked and looked and looked. I could not find the original unblurred version of the audio that we played for you last night. So these are very difficult videos to find the actual original versions of. In this case, this one does seem to be the uncut original version, and we're going to continue with John Cantley here in a moment.
Is the Islamic State like making intellectual property complaints to YouTube?
No.
You better take that video down, or we'll cut your mother's head off.
No, just to be clear, what's happening is ISIS allegedly is releasing these videos to the internet, We don't know by what channel they're being released, because it'd be nice if ISIS just had a YouTube channel that we could just subscribe to get all of these things. I only find out about them when I see mainstream media articles about them existing. Then I have to go and search and search and search and try to find the actual video. So what's happening is, with the prior video that we played last night on the show, Chris, all of the versions had been blurred out, and they weren't going to be. They didn't release that originally like that. Why would they blur out the photos that they were using in their own video to illustrate? So what was happening was the people who were putting the video online, who were not ISIS, just the people, just random people uploading it to their YouTube channel. Somebody blurred that out so they wouldn't get copyright strikes on their channel.
Right.
See what I'm saying?
Okay.
So it wasn't ISIS that was blurring their own video. Mark, we'll continue that here in a moment.
Yeah, we're heading off to Orlando here at the end of this week.
Yeah,
it's gonna
Friday.
It's going to be really exciting. We're going to Coins in the Kingdom. It's at coinsinthekingdom.com. It's an event. It's a Bitcoin party, and they're going to have lots of speakers there, and it's going to be a great time. As a matter of fact, today we were just coming up with some scavenger hunts for the kids.
There's kids going to be at this Bitcoin event.
Entirely different sort of a Bitcoin event than the ones you may have been to in the past. And if you're in the area, come on down. It's going to be a lot of fun. Coinsinthekingdom.com. It's at the Wyndham Lake Buena Vista in downtown Disney. Saturday, October the 4th and 5th. For the event itself, Coins in the Kingdom, and then on the 6th, everybody's going to Disney World. Now, you and I, we're not going to do the Disney thing. We're just heading back to New Hampshire.
We're going back to work.
But that's exactly what's happening. But tickets are $60 for the event. It's going to be a lot of fun. Please come out and see us. Hotel rooms, $99. Kids under 12, free. Funds mandatory. Come celebrate Magic Internet Money at the Magic Kingdom with us, coinsinthekingdom.com.
I mean, if you're anywhere in the Southeast, that seems like it's well worth it. $60 for a weekend plus $99 hotel rooms. You can't beat that.
Yeah.
At Disney World. So we'll continue here in with the video from ISIS. This is their most recent video, just released a couple days ago, where John Cantley, their spokesman, their forced spokesman ostensibly, is delivering a prepared statement into a video camera. And this one, he's kind of breaking down Barack Obama and what the, you know, the supposed plan is as far as how to stop ISIS with bombs, and then apparently not just bombs, because Barack Obama had pointed out that, oh, we're not going to use a single American ground troop. Well, they're going to be using other ground troops. And in this case, they're going to be using, what was it, the Free Syrian Army, I believe is what they called themselves.
Yep.
And
the moderate rebels who are violently overthrowing their government.
And ISIS alleges, or the people claiming to be ISIS in this video, allege that the Free Syrian Army is a bunch of scumbags who are going to be selling the millions of dollars, hundreds of millions of dollars worth of equipment that they'll be receiving from the U.S. federal government to ISIS, ultimately.
Well,
that's what they alleged.
Yeah, and it's totally plausible because that's
kind of how these things generally tend to wind up.
So let's continue with the video here.
Which goes a long way in explaining the simplistic language used in his last speech. Obama was at pains to point out that groups of killers have the capacity to do great harm. That was the case before 9/11 and remains today. If this reality wasn't changed by two arrogant wars before, why will a third change it now? Obama described the Islamic State as not Islamic. No religion condones the killing of innocents, and a vast majority of their victims have been Muslim. The Islamic State has no vision other than the slaughter of all who stand in its way. Now, if by innocence he means women and children, then the Islamic State did not kill the Christian and Yazidi women and children of Mosul and Sinjar. This is an undeniable fact. And they do not regard the Shia as Muslims at all. In fact, according to them, the Shia are considered worse than Americans.
Wait a second. Did he claim that they did or did not? Something was an undeniable fact that they did or did not
kill Christian women and children.
Okay. Because, I mean, I'd heard, you heard these news stories. I wasn't sure. The pictures were, shown to be old. Like, it was just a bunch of, a big mess around that whole beheading of innocents thing.
As they are apostates claiming to be Muslims while worshipping the dead. And the Islamic State does have a vision. They've created an autonomous and functioning caliphate. But expanding on the complex social and political issues of the region isn't going to work when it's war you want. And so the speech was full of hyperbole about how America was saving innocent men, women, and children. This is American leadership at its best, said Obama. We stand with people who fight for their own freedom, he said, before the speech descended into prideful chest beating about how the USA always saves the world single-handedly. It was all disappointingly predictable. America is good, the Islamic State is bad, and they will be defeated using aircraft and a motley collection of fighters on the ground. For their part, the Islamic State say they welcome meeting Obama's under-construction army. Join me again for the next program.
Yes, and I imagine that we will, because I find this all very interesting.
Yeah. So you said you didn't see Obama's speech?
Did not. Did you?
I did. I picked it up on YouTube, you know, later on that evening or the next day. But it was, I think it gives a pretty accurate description of what Obama's speech was.
Predictable.
You know, it's just very like, hey, look, we're going to go kill a bunch of people, and I have the power to do this, and I don't even need to ask Congress. And, you know, maybe I'll ask Congress if I can give hundreds of millions of dollars of weapons to violent radical forces in the Middle East and see if that pans out real well.
Because it's worked so well in the past,
right? I mean, it seems to me that this is just so predictable, right? I mean, they armed the Mujahideen in Afghanistan when the Russians invaded, and that spun off into Al Qaeda, and then Al Qaeda goes and allegedly bombs a few buildings here in the United States, and then they launch wars on two different countries, and the outcome of this is ISIS. And
right.
So you go and you start messing around with this hornet's nest, and you can just imagine what's going to follow that, because ISIS,
it isn't
going
to be good.
And the ISIS situation, I mean, if you look at it, I mean, I'm certainly not in favor of any like U.S. military action against this group of people, but it certainly doesn't look like these are good folks, right? These are some really dangerous people, and there's a lot of them, and they are well armed, and they're taking over vast swaths of territory, and this is something that we're just going to make worse in some way, and I'm terrified by it.
Yeah, and that's a great point, that the continued escalation of violence just attracts the more violent. There's more coming up.
Ever wonder why so many politicians violate the U.S. Constitution? Maybe they simply don't understand its principles. Fiat empire, original intent, cultural Marxism, corporate fascism, and Molon Labe explore these issues. Featuring experts like Ron Paul, G. Edward Griffin, Edwin Vieira, Pat Buchanan, John McManus, Larry Pratt, this 12-hour, 8-DVD set is available only at moviepubs.net.
Wake up and smell the freedom. One of the easiest things you can do to help Liberty is to torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to help keep them drone-proof. You can set up your home computer to download and share Freedom Fiends archives over BitTorrent. You can even set up scheduling so it only shares while you're asleep or at work. Put your unused computing power to work and help keep the Freedom Fiends around well into the future. Simply go to freedomfiends.com and click on the Torrent Club link and learn how to torrent and share Freedom Fiends archives.
Have you heard? Proactive Plus is faster and better than ever. Stay tuned for a million bottle giveaway, and you'll also receive free shipping. Do you have troubled skin? Acne? Well, we have great news. With Proactive Plus, your acne can heal, and you can help prevent new breakouts from happening. Don't miss this limited-time offer. Give us a call at 800-538-5252, because we're going to let a million people try Proactive Plus risk-free and get two free gifts and also receive free shipping when you call right now. You heard it. This offer won't last long. So call Proactive Plus now, and you'll receive a 60-day risk-free trial of Proactive Plus, two free extras, and free shipping. Call 800-538-5252. This is our exclusive radio offer, never on TV. Get your risk-free 60-day trial of Proactive Plus with free shipping. That's right, free shipping. Don't wait. Call 800-538-5252. That's 800-538-5252.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up what you want by dialing toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. We've been sharing with you the audio track of the most recent ISIS video, and they're coming out about once a week at this point, so expect a new one.
Maybe they're not an army, but really just a video production company.
Well, they certainly seem to have a proficient video production wing. The quality is decent. It's HD that they're putting out, and John Cantley, their host, who's also a prisoner, is watchable.
I hope that someday some garbage podcast can be as good as ISIS.
Oh God,
22,000 views so far on this particular video. So they're and again, this isn't even hosted by any kind of ISIS channel, which is my big complaint. Is hey guys, come on. Get with the program here. We're in the new 21st century. Everybody's got their own YouTube channel. Why doesn't ISIS have an official channel? Why do I have to find out about the ISIS videos just by happening to see some sort of news story about it in my news feed somewhere? I'm actually concerned that I'll miss one of these things because it's just I just happen across them.
I'm going to go ahead and guess that YouTube would be taking down any official ISIS channel. I know that
that's unfortunate.
Even Twitter was pulling anything linking to like beheading videos. The most recent beheading video, Twitter was pulling stuff down, and Twitter used to like never censor anything. I mean, had situations where like child pornography has been like trending on Twitter.
Even Live Leak would not allow the beheading videos.
Yeah,
which was a surprise to me. In fact, Live Leak. Put out Live Leak, for those that don't know, Live Leak is this alternative to YouTube that is sort of known for having more, let's say, violent or gory videos, the stuff that generally wouldn't be allowed on YouTube. Live Leak has sort of made a name for itself as being the location where you can go for that stuff. And then when I was, again, searching for these beheading videos, because it's so hard to find them, then I went, of course, to Live Leak, and they had a statement up there saying, this is the first time we've ever not put something up like this, and they gave their reasons for it. They're basically, to summarize, was they didn't want to give ISIS any extra publicity.
I guess they should start uploading the videos to funnyordie.com or something.
See, I think it's interesting, the whole choice to put something put something up or not put something up. Because the United States is killing people in the Middle East with bombs.
Yes.
There have been 250 last I heard Tomahawk missiles lobbed into these areas, and those kill people. They may or may not have their heads when the bombs go off, but for some reason, executions via beheading is this terrible thing to people in the West or something.
Mm-hmm.
And the responsibility, are we showing pictures? Are there videos coming out of dead people that have been killed by U.S. bombs? Yes, there are. Why are they putting those up? Does that increase the, you know, is that a good thing for the U.S.? It seems like a bad thing for the U.S.
It seems to me that there are exceedingly few of those videos out there, though, because for all the bombs that the United States drops in, you know, how many different war zones that it's currently involved in, I don't see a great number of those videos. Now, I'm sure that there's not a whole lot of incentive to be the cameraman at one of those sites.
Well, right. It's hard to get shots of that, if you think about it. Most of the videos we've seen over the years of American troops wreaking havoc have been leaked, like the WikiLeaks kind of videos, which usually you'll see them from the troops' helicopter or whatever that is hovering there, and you'll see in sort of the, I don't know if it's like night vision, but it looks like it's
forward-looking infrared.
There you go, FLIR. So you don't really see great detail of what's happening. You can see that there are humans on the ground and that there's gunshots or whatever coming in and they're being taken out or explosions, but it's not as gory. It's not as, it doesn't seem as personal as a beheading video does, right?
Yeah, like it almost looks like a video game or something. And
unfortunately, yeah. And of course, that's one of the reasons why the U.S. military is able to recruit new people, because they're able to get people to just control drones and things like that. And they don't, you know, they're disconnected from the actual killing that is being done. Now, when you look at a beheading video, you have an individual who is sitting there. In the case of the ISIS videos, they're kneeling on the ground and they're being talked about and they're speaking, and then they're allegedly, ostensibly beheaded. It's much more personal when that happens, and so it's not a surprise that a video like that would be more upsetting to people.
Yeah, and I think that's sort of the whole point of the videos. It's supposed to, you know, give people a reaction that's negative, right? They're supposed to see the video and say, hey, this is terrible. I don't want to see this. Whatever is causing this to happen, I want it to stop. Right, so they're putting out those videos with that, you know, intention, and the people who want this to continue are incentivized at all costs to make sure that people don't see that.
You'd want, I don't want to say I'd love to see bombing videos. I prefer not to ever see something like that. But
if they're going to happen, I'd love to see the videos of it.
To actually get a video of like a little girl running through the streets when a bomb goes off, and to see the damage and the horrifying destruction that that causes is next to impossible. Possible because the camera itself would have to survive the explosion, and so you're never going to see that. You know, you can see a fictionalized version of it in some Hollywood movie, because then it's all CGI and the camera's, you know, not really there, not really, you know, subject to being blown up. But, you know, in reality, that's what's happening. Innocent human beings are having their limbs torn from it, their
just
bodies
blown
and
to pieces,
horrible
yeah.
bits and giblets and chunks everywhere, and you can't see that happen except from, you know, a disconnected perspective from some helicopter or some jet flying over. And so we'll never see, or very unlikely to ever see, footage like that. We'll never see the real results in real time of what happens with these bombings beyond from a distance.
So, but I mean, I wonder if, you know, I mean, here in the United States, I mean, there's some statistic and I can't recall what it is, but you're on camera, you know, X percentage of your entire life. I mean, there's never any like an ATM camera or a security camera across the street that catches one of these bombings or something like that. I've got to imagine that this footage has to exist somewhere, and people are just, for whatever reason, either not uploading it or it's getting taken down by YouTube censors and that sort of thing.
The only pictures I ever see are these bombed out places that you couldn't put an ATM or anything
else.
Yeah,
you
like
see
that.
The remnants. You can see pictures of what it looks like in the aftermath, and I'm sure there's plenty of blood splatter that you could take photos of, but the actual bombing itself would be very difficult to accomplish a capture on video.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah, it's not easy.
So share your thoughts with us here. Toll free, 855-450-FREE, because why wouldn't a group like ISIS, who obviously wants to curry favor with people, I mean, to some extent, they have these propaganda videos they're coming out with. Why wouldn't they distribute a video like that? Why wouldn't they, you know, if those videos did exist?
If anyone from ISIS is listening, please try to get this footage. I don't know how many ISIS members listen to Free Talk Live, but if you are listening, we want videos of the carnage that the United States is causing, because we know all too well about the damage that you're doing.
Right. And by the way, just one of the points on this video here, and then we'll talk about the Syrian bombings, the Syrian continuing the discussion of airstrikes. Apparently now they've lifted whatever restrictions were on the Syrian airstrikes, so now they're going to be killing more innocent people there. But the very one of the last points made by John Cantley in this video is he's pointing out that the U.S. government's perspective on this, their public statement, is essentially that U.S. government good, you know, the ISIS bad, or the Islamic State bad. And it's my opinion that all states are bad. So I don't, you know, I'm not saying the Islamic State are the good guys here. Just because we're playing their propaganda videos doesn't mean I'm on their side. But all states are bad. The United States, bad. Islamic State, bad. Anybody who wants to control other human beings and is willing to kill and harm just to try to achieve their goals, I have
the
a problem
lie
with.
We've been told all our lives is that we are the government. And if that is the case, then we need to have the information, as much information as we can get about making decisions when it comes around foreign policy. And if the United States is going to become involved in yet another protracted, costly, deadly war in the Middle East, the people that are going to be making decisions in 2014 and 2016 need to know. They need to know. Because what I see is the war party and the more war party. Mm. I don't
which
see a difference.
Which?
As far as I'm concerned, the Democrats, they act like they fight and they want to kill and destroy. They just act like they don't like it.
I do think that if you had, you know, a John McCain as president or something like that right now, I mean, you'd have a full on ground invasion over there. I definitely call the Republican Party the more war party.
That's how I see
Fair
it.
Fair enough.
Here in New Hampshire, the Republicans voted to demilitarize the police. So I don't think that that's every Republican everywhere. But
at the national level, yeah.
At the national level, when you give Republicans armies, I don't trust them. So, I'm a Republican.
Share your thoughts here with us tonight. There's news about the Syrian bombings, which apparently, Mark, you're going to tell us here in a moment that there were some sort of restrictions on the targets they could bomb. But
yes.
Now those have been lifted. We'll give you more information about that here in moments. The toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. And Rand Paul, what does he have to say about this ISIS stuff? Because he's supposedly a libertarian. Well, we'll find out here in a little bit. And your calls and thoughts are certainly welcome. Plus, we talked in detail last night about Ebola. And Chris Cantwell would like to talk about how do you handle this stuff without the state. That's all coming up on Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Pure Life Water, helping you drink better and live better by providing a zero-calorie alternative to sugary drinks. Visit us at nestle-purelife.us. When kids are playing, they often don't want to stop to keep hydrated. So send them out with a bottle of water and encourage them to take frequent drink breaks or call them inside for a quick sip. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Wednesday, October 1st, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,208. Silver opened at $17.28. And Bitcoin is trading around $381.59. Today's Bitcoin price is brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. Vote Michael Cargill to get the cars moving. Learn more or sign up to volunteer at cargillfortexas.com. Political advertisement paid for by the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. In the news today, the first case of Ebola diagnosed in the United States was confirmed yesterday in a patient who recently traveled from Liberia to Dallas, a sign of the far-reaching impact of the out-of-control epidemic in West Africa. The unidentified man was critically ill and has been in isolation at Texas Health Presbyterian Hospital in Dallas, Texas, since Sunday. That word from federal health officials. They would not reveal his nationality or age. On Tuesday, California Governor Jerry Brown signed into law a bill that would allow the temporary seizure of guns from individuals who the courts deem to be a threat to themselves or others. Under the new law, law enforcement officers can ask courts for restraining orders, which would bar the individual from possessing a firearm for 21 days. The measure was supported by Democrats and anti-gun groups and opposed by the NRA and Gun Owners of California. Charles H. Cunningham, a director with the NRA's Institute for Legislative Action, called the law one of the most egregious violations of civil liberties ever introduced in the California legislature. China's government has cut off news about Hong Kong's pro-democracy protests to the rest of the country, a clampdown so thorough that no image of the rallies has appeared in state-controlled media, and at least one man has been detained for reposting accounts of the events. By contrast, media in semi-autonomous Hong Kong have been broadcasting nonstop about the crowds, showing unarmed students fending off tear gas and pepper spray with umbrellas as they call for more representative democracy in the former British colony. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Cabo Bob's, Southwestern-style burritos, now with two locations in Austin, 500 East Ben White Boulevard and 2828 Rio Grande Boulevard. Find them online, cabobobs.com. And support comes from Sovereign Living, a podcast, blog, and reality show about what it takes to live a voluntary and natural life. Check out the blog at sovereignliving.com and watch episode 1 of the soon-to-be-released reality show at sovereignliving.tv. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, October 1st, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook, facebook.com/thelibertybeat. The Federal Communications Commission chairman will consider a petition that asks the agency to consider fining broadcasters with the National Football League who continue to use the Redskins name when referring to the Washington football team. Activist John Banzhoff III has registered a petition with the FCC, asking the regulatory agency to strip Washington radio station WWXXFM of its broadcasting license for using what he says is a racist and hateful word. If the FCC agrees with the petition, broadcasters would be punished for using the football team name. The Washington Redskins is also currently battling the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office after they canceled the team's trademark registration based on alleged racism. A new study published in the journal JAMA Pediatrics indicates that frequent prescribing of broad-spectrum antibiotics increases the risk of obesity in children. The study found that babies who were given broad-spectrum antibiotics in the first 2 years of life were more likely to be obese between their second and fifth birthdays than those children who had taken no antibiotics or narrow-spectrum antibiotics. While broad-spectrum antibiotics are found to be highly effective, they can also kill off beneficial bacteria the body needs. The study examined medical records of nearly 65,000 babies and children from the Philadelphia area. The increased risk of obesity was about 11% higher for children who had taken antibiotics versus those who did not. Today's edition of the Liberty Beat is brought to you by Brave New Books, your source for One World Way, Tangy Tangerine, and Clearly Filtered Fluoride Filters. Located in Austin, Texas at 1904 Guadalupe Street, or find them online at bravenewbookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, October 1st, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
This is the Onion Week in Review. In a landmark 5-4 decision issued this Wednesday, the Supreme Court ruled to allow Americans to cram cash directly into politicians' mouths. The ruling, which effectively eradicates former prohibitions against stuffing checks and stacks of $100 bills straight down the throats, ears, and other orifices of presidential and congressional candidates, is expected to fundamentally alter the ways American politicians have large quantities of money shoved right into their bodies.
In football music news this week, the 1985 Chicago Bears reunite to record their first new material since the Super Bowl Shuffle. The group says the new material will be darker and more introspective than its Shuffle era work.
And in this week's op-ed pages, a man asks why, if God exists, doesn't he throw us like a really f***ing sweet party? In other news, an increasing number of men feel pressured to accept realistic standards of female beauty. FedEx confirms that more than 600,000 people try to mail themselves each year. And a recovering alcoholic doesn't need friends to have a good time.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, talking about bombings, specifically the Syrian bombings, and apparently there's been some change on policy on how that stuff's supposed to work. Mark will be giving us those details. They're loosening up the alleged tight restrictions on who can be bombed. And also, still to come here tonight, what's old Rand Paul have to say about ISIS? We were talking about ISIS in the last hour. Plus, you know, people think Rand Paul's a libertarian. He says he's not. And so I think we should go with what he says. And in fact, his words will make it very clear that he's not a libertarian, as you'll find out here in moments. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. As we continue here, you can bring up anything. You can also join us online at freetalklive.com. So, Mark, what is going on with the Syrian raids?
This is from news.yahoo.com. The White House has acknowledged for the first time that the strict standards that President Obama imposed last year to prevent civilian deaths from U.S. drone strikes will not apply to U.S. military operations in Syria and Iraq. So,
okay.
You know, there's all kinds of terrible news out about how the United States was killing 49 innocent people for every one terrorist. They were doing things that they were called double taps, where they would drop a bomb. Mm. Some people would be harmed. Others would rush in to
like
help.
Like an ambulance or something.
Yeah, and then they'd drop a bomb again. These are horrifyingly these are evil things to do.
Was done under these tight restrictions.
Those things were done, and then the Obama administration's like, well, we'll just go ahead and we'll put some restrictions on how we do the bombing thing.
It's PR. It's a PR move, and now they're quietly removing them, it seems.
Well, it's not that quiet. No? It's in several news items have been on. Featured this.
Why was this necessary? Well, I wonder what their excuse is.
Well, we'll read on.
We just really need to kill some more innocents. Those terrorists, they're hiding amongst the innocents, and the only way we can do this without sending in ground troops, we got to save the American lives, is to just bomb everybody. I mean, what are they saying?
A White House statement to Yahoo News confirming the looser policy came in response to questions about reports that as many as a dozen civilians, including women and young children, were killed when a Tomahawk missile struck the village of Kafir Daryan in Syria's Idlib province in the morning of September the 23rd. The village was described by Syrian rebel commanders as a reported stronghold of the Al-Qaeda-linked Nusra Front,
yeah,
where U.S. officials believed members of the so-called
We will be very careful to not bomb civilians unless they are among a stronghold. So, therefore, they'll just label everything a stronghold, right? It's a stronghold. We need to bomb it.
Yeah, as long as it's a stronghold, it's fine. Khorasan Group, they were plotting attacks against international aircraft. So, people were there that were plotting terrible things about...
So, they claim.
International aircraft is the claim. Of course, they're going to attack civilians and not military aircraft, which is up there flying, too. Why would they want to go for the civilian aircraft? Whatever. At a briefing, we have to kill some women and children. So, but a briefing for members and staffers of the House Foreign Affairs Committee late last week, Syrian rebel commanders described women and children being hauled from the rubble after an errant cruise missile destroyed a home for displaced civilians. Images of badly injured children also appeared on YouTube, helping to fuel anti-U.S. protests in a number of Syrian villages last week. Now, I'm always curious about the blowback people, the people that are anti-blowback. Like, no, the people in the Middle East hate us for our freedoms. Why was there a protest? If people in the Middle East hate you for your freedoms, why was there a protest about an errant Tomahawk missile killing children? They shouldn't protest if they're not willing to kill you for, you know, decades of intervention in the Middle East that you have, you know, largely ignored and gone on with your life about. Then why in the world would they bother having a protest? They don't care about those things, right? They don't care about their children. They don't care about their husbands. They don't care about their wives. They care about Britney Spears showing too much cleavage. They care about your Christian religion. For God's sakes, they care which holy book you have. That's why they want to kill you, for God's sakes. It has nothing to do with their dead moms.
I think that this might have been what Cantley was talking about here. You're talking about this area. I lost the name, but he had mentioned that, you know, it wasn't us that killed these Christian women and children and whatnot.
Us being ISIS.
Yeah, that's what Cantley said in the video, that it wasn't them who had killed these Christian women and children. And apparently, I wonder if this is what he's referring to, this bombing strike in Syria.
I don't know.
I'm not sure of the timeline.
These were displaced civilians, so I imagine that most of them were Muslim, would be my guess. So anyway, going on. It says here that I saw 7 or 8 ambulances coming out of there, said Abu Abdu Salambram, a political member of one of the Free Syrian Army factions who attended a briefing for Foreign Affairs Committee members and staff. We believe this was a big mistake. They were carrying bodies out of the rubble. And so asked about the strike at Kafir Duran, a U.S. Central Command spokesman on Tuesday, said that the U.S. military did target a Khorasan group compound near this location. However, we have seen no evidence at this time to corroborate claims of civilian casualties.
So just to clarify, what you're saying is this bombing happened, the Free Syrian Army, which was talked about in the ISIS video we played in the last hour, they've got members who are saying, look, we saw innocent people bombed by these U.S. bombs. The U.S. military saying, no, there's no evidence for that. Is that what I'm hearing you say?
Yeah, well, at this point, they're saying we're taking all accusations, you know, that are credible seriously. But
that they've seen no evidence for the bombing. So on one hand, you've got guys on the ground saying, yeah, you just killed a bunch of women and children, and the U.S. military's response is, no, we didn't.
They're guys,
and the guys
on the ground.
And the guys who are saying it are the guys that they're about to send a whole bunch of weapons to.
Yeah.
Their guys on the ground are saying that this occurred. And
their guys meaning the Free Syrian Army.
The Free Syrian Army. Well,
is the U.S. teaming up with these guys to supposedly
prosecute
this.
That's what they do.
War.
Don't worry. We'll be fighting them in 3 years.
Yeah, these are the moderate rebels who are violently overthrowing their government.
I shouldn't say
if they were moderate before, as soon as they kill some more of their women and children,
they're
going to
get really moderate.
Yeah.
So the White House says that the much-publicized White House policy that President Obama announced last year, barring U.S. drone strikes, unless there's a near certainty there will be no civilian casualties, the highest standard we can meet, he said at the time, does not cover the current U.S. airstrikes in Iraq and Syria. No. Sorry about that. That's new. That doesn't apply.
So it did apply, but now it doesn't, or it never applied?
It did apply. I mean, no, it did not apply. This is now a war.
Yeah.
This isn't just our normal bombing of peaceful places.
I've not bombed anyone.
This is a war of. This is a bombing in a wartime situation.
Gotcha.
So, yeah, so those really strict standards that really didn't pan out so well from the get-go, these have now been taken off the table. And so the really, the really safe drone bombings that were happening that were killing innocent women and children are about to become a great deal less safe, apparently.
Or apparently not about to, but what I'm hearing is that ever since Obama's statement about going into Syria, they've just been bombing whatever the hell they want.
Yeah.
That's what I'm understanding from this?
Well, they've been...
I think it's always been that way, but now they're not even trying to, like, you know, pave it over with sugar. You know, they're just like, hey, guess what? We're a bunch of murderous thugs, and you can take it or leave it.
Well, they say, like all U.S. military operations are being conducted, these are being conducted consistent with laws of armed conflict and proportionality and distinction.
Just take their word for it. Clearly, they're following
the law. They don't
even
believe that they did it.
Right, proportionality, that's an interesting one.
Sure. Yeah. I mean, you believe the government when they make claims, right? I mean, so they're following their own. Oh, wait, no. We've got all kinds of evidence that the government doesn't even follow their own laws. They're claiming they're following some sort of conflict law. But who can really prove that statement's true? It's just a claim.
Well, I would sincerely hope that most people in the U.S. military wouldn't just go ahead and bomb civilian targets unless they believe that there was some terrorist hiding amongst
them. What the hell
makes
you think they wouldn't do that?
I don't think that they would just go ahead and bomb civilians.
Do whatever the hell they're told to do.
Yeah, I don't think that there's any thought process there for the soldiers. The soldiers are told to go bomb something. They might be presuming that they're ordered to go bomb something because it's a legitimate military target.
Indeed.
But they have no concept of this stuff. They have no idea what they're shooting at. They're just like, hey, go kill these guys. And
there's
they're like,
terrorists hiding in that hospital.
That's what I mean.
Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Your thoughts are welcome here on Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Hey guys, if you're into fantasy football, you've got to check out FanDuel.com. At FanDuel, you play in one-week fantasy football leagues for real money with immediate cash payouts. You only play when you want, and you can change your team any week. FanDuel is paying out over $10 million every week this season. And right now, FanDuel is giving you up to $200 free. That's right, for every dollar you deposit, FanDuel will match it up to $200. Just go to FanDuel.com, click the microphone in the upper right corner, and enter code FOOTBALL70. FANDUEL.com, code FOOTBALL, the number 70.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Help get LRN.fm into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial toll free here, at least until until we get bombed. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And I'm not talking about getting bombed as in getting drunk. We're talking about the bombings going on over in Syria. They're not happening here in America, thank goodness. But, you know, and that's one of the things is that Americans are more tolerant towards bombings, as we were discussing bombing videos versus beheading videos and why people care about one but not the other. There's also this sort of ethnocentrism of, oh, well, they're not humans. They're not as good as us folks here in America. That's, I think, a common perspective. Whether or not people would admit to it is another point.
Yeah, I don't think it would be easy to do stuff like this to English-speaking Europeans.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think that they did do things like that. They bombed Dresden. What it is it's about the... Well, I guess they're not English-speaking there. I'm sure they did some terrible things to Canadians and Britons during, you know, the Revolutionary War and the War of 1812. But it's a tribal thing. It's humans do this. Mm. They say, this is our team, that's their team. And everything that's done to our team is bad, and everything that's done to their team is fine because they have the wrong religion, they eat the wrong foods, they look the wrong way, they act the wrong way, they treat their children the wrong way, they do all kinds of things the wrong way, so the things that we do to them are fine.
Not to mention all those weird hats.
Yeah, hats are important.
Your hats.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and there are bounties available right now at bitcoinbountyhunter.com. One of them's worth 38 Bitcoin. You do the math. Bitcoins are around $400 a pop. That's a lot of money. You can actually use your investigative skills and collect the bounty, and you can even place your own bounty or add to the ones that already exist. The authorities aren't going to be solving these cases. If they get solved, it's going to be done by somebody like you, someone who can profit from your work and skills. Go check out BitcoinBountyHunter.com. And again, that's BitcoinBountyHunter.com. Now, Mark has been sharing with us a story. And what, by the way, is the source on this?
Yahoo News.
Yahoo News. About the Syrian bombings that have been going on, where apparently there was some statement made earlier this year about how, well, we've got tight standards now. We're implementing tight standards on what can and can't be bombed as far as civilian targets. And apparently none of those standards apply anymore and haven't applied since the beginnings of the earnest bombings in Syria as of a couple weeks ago. And so now more innocent people will be able to be killed without any sort of question whatsoever. That's the news.
Which makes the job a lot easier for the people who have to do the killing. I mean, you know, if you're going to be like, hey, are there innocent people over here? And you're not really sure who your enemy is anymore because you've pissed off such a huge portion of a population, you know, mm-hmm. It makes it a lot easier when you could just indiscriminately kill.
Yep, and that's what they're going to do. The suggestion or the questioner was brought up by Mark. Well, wouldn't these American military members not bomb innocent people if they knew they were bombing innocent people? And I think that is an important question, but I don't believe that they wouldn't. I think that they would absolutely do anything they were told to do. Maybe some would do it begrudgingly. Maybe they would complain or gripe about it. Maybe they, you know, would feel sad as a result of what they had done. But ultimately, their job is to do what they're told. And if we actually had any level of of disobedience among the military, we'd see more news stories about people saying, yeah, I'm not doing this. This is sick. This is wrong. And we're bailing out of this.
If police in the United States are willing to kill people over plant material, then you could imagine that soldiers in a foreign war zone are not going to be too discriminatory, frankly.
Especially when they've been told these are bad guys.
The discriminatory thing is one thing. Somebody weighs in their mind how bad is the bad guy in that building that has 10 kids in it. They say to themselves, okay, well, those kids will probably grow up to be terrorists or whatever, so it's worth it to get the bad guy. That's one thing. But to say, to suggest, and I do not believe for a second that this is the case, that somebody says, you know what would be a good idea? Let's use a $1.5 million Tomahawk missile to blow up this house with just 10 kids in it, because they might grow up to be terrorists. I mean, that's a terrible idea.
No one's going to tell that, even if they knew.
No,
that the
I know. That's why. Right. Like, it's stupid to suggest that that would be the idea, because they'll never do that. The commanding officer will always be of the opinion that the bad guy's there, the bad guy's worth getting. Yeah. This is what we have to do.
We've got intelligence from on the ground that says there's a terrorist hiding in that school.
They won't mention that kids are there. Yeah. The kids are evacuated. They'll do what they'll say and do whatever they need to do to get the building blown up, because the average person doesn't want to do that. Well, that's all I'm saying.
And what passes for intelligence at this point is that some source within the community or something tells you that there's some problem there, right? Yeah. And so that could be anything from somebody who owes somebody money, says, oh, hey, the guy I owe money to, you know, he's plotting attacks on the United States. And, you know, next thing you know, he's out of debt because a Thomas Hawk missile dropped on his neighbor.
Exactly. Is there more from this story, Mark, that you want to share that's worth sharing?
Yeah, there's. I've actually had to move around because you suggested that this was earlier this year, and I couldn't figure out whether the more strict things went in last year or this year. But okay. I don't think they've been around for much more than a year. So questions about civilian deaths from U.S. counterterrorism operations have confronted the Obama administration from the onset after the president sharply ramped up drone strikes in Pakistan and Yemen, resulting sometimes in heated internal policy debates. Addressing the subject last year in a speech at the National Defense University, Obama acknowledged for the first time that U.S. airstrikes have resulted in civilian casualties, adding, "For me and for those in my chain of command, those deaths will haunt us for as long as we live." Sources familiar with the new near-certainty standard Obama announced at the time, so this was last year that it was announced, said that it was, as a practical matter, it meant that every drone strike had to be signed off at the White House, first by Lisa Monaco, Obama's chief Homeland Security advisor, and then ultimately by the president himself. The policy, one source said, caused some Pentagon officials to chafe at the new restrictions and led to a noticeable reduction in such strikes by the military and the CIA. If all of these strikes were righteous before, why did the number decrease that the ones presented to the president to sign?
That's a good point, I think, because if they're if they're clearly in a situation where they're saying, well, all our strikes are justified and we're doing everything that we can to avoid civilian casualties, and I mean, they've been saying that from the outset of the thing, right? Sure. I mean, from the moment that they go into Afghanistan, they always talk about, hey, we're going to do everything that we can to reduce civilian casualties because that's not what we're there to do. We're there to fight their government, not them, yada, yada, yada. Well, clearly not, right? Because as soon as you implement some minor restriction, you know, just you have to get approval from somebody in order to do this, well, all of a sudden the number of strikes that you do drop because you don't want to, you don't have even near certainty, which qualified as near certainty prior to this order, right?
Right.
You presumably, if the standard is near certainty, and you have been saying from the outset that you're going to do what you can to reduce civilian deaths, and then you're met with a near certainty standard, and your number drops, well, yeah, it would stand obvious to reason that you didn't have near certainty prior.
Yeah, you don't know what near certainty is. Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, I find it very disturbing. So while the White House has said little about the standards it is using for strikes in Syria and Iraq, one former official who has been briefed on the matter said the looser policy gives more discretion to theater commanders of the U.S. Central Command to select targets without the same level of White House oversight. If you throw 250 Tomahawk missiles into a given theater of battle, you're going to miss. You're going to hit women and children. This is the reality. If I went out and I started shooting after some criminal that had harmed me at my house and I killed some baby in a carriage, I'd be called a murderer. I love my Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. mymagicmud.com.
Hi, I'm John Rainey, Chief Financial Officer of United Airlines, and I'm honored to be the National Chair for the 2015 March for Babies campaign for the March of Dimes. United is a proud supporter of the March of Dimes mission to improve the health of babies and fight premature birth. We're helping the March of Dimes fund breakthroughs in research and community programs that help more mothers have full-term pregnancies and healthy babies. Please join us in working together for stronger, healthier babies. Visit marchofdimes.org.
Andrew Michael Jones is a liberty-loving activist and participant in the Free State Project. He's also been accused of being one of the administrators of the infamous Silk Road Anonymous Black Marketplace. Andrew is facing a federal trial for multiple crimes with no victim. Whether or not he's the Silk Road administrator named Inigo, he has not been accused of harming anyone. In fact, the Silk Road is actually an amazing advancement that has reduced the overall harm of the black market to both customers and drug sellers. Whether or not he did it, Andrew, like alleged Silk Road founder Ross Ulbricht, deserves the support of people who love liberty. Visit drewsdefense.org to learn more and contribute to his defense. You can donate via PayPal or in Bitcoin, as I did. That's drewsdefense.org. Drew's family does not have much, and his parents have put up their home and both retirement incomes to secure a $1 million bond on Andrew. He's currently on 24/7 house arrest and is prohibited from touching any device that could connect to the internet. Please contribute to his defense fund via drewsdefense.org.
If you want to move to the free state, you're looking for some real estate. Well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres? A lakeside cabin? Any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Hewlett-Packard is known for their basic, no-frills computers, but that doesn't mean they can't keep up with the latest technology. In a press release yesterday, HP said, quote, "We are excited to begin offering that cloud thing that everyone is talking about. We definitely have the cloud on our computers, and it is better than anyone else's cloud." Earlier today, I sat down with HP spokesman Gary Klinman, who said the company couldn't wait to show people, quote, "how they do their cloud stuff."
"We are absolutely thrilled that now people with computers or phones, both, will now be able to back things up to the cloud."
Klinman says it isn't surprising they're, quote, "up on the cloud," considering they're on the cutting edge of all the latest tech trends.
"Are there any additional features?"
"Crowdsourcing is something we are having. Crowdsourcing 2.0. We have social sharing. We have 5G, 6G, really all the Gs. We have app. We have all of it in the computer."
This is the Onion News Network.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Talk Live. Dial toll-free 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Discussing the bombings that are and have gone on in Syria. Also Iraq. They apparently had put on some sort of extra standards regarding what can and can't be bombed or could not be bombed in the past. And those standards have been lifted. And presumably they've been lifted as of a few weeks ago. Not real clear on the dates of all of this. But regardless, they no longer exist, and the U.S. military can now bomb whatever they want to bomb, whenever they want to bomb it, and all they have to do is claim that, you know, there's terrorists. "We're terrorists! We've got to bomb these schools and hospitals or houses."
And so Mark is sharing that story with us. We'll continue, and certainly would love to hear from you at 855-450-FREE+. You can join us via Skype. I don't think I mentioned that yet. We've got the Skype username lrn.fm. Just send us a contact request there. It will be approved within moments, and then it'll be easy for you to call us on Skype. Now, when you get online, you need to really consider your privacy, and there are certain steps you need to take to protect your privacy. ProXPN should be one of those steps. It's an affordable one, and it works very well. They're a virtual private network that's global, and they encrypt your data, meaning that before whatever you're doing online reaches your internet service provider, it's encrypted by ProXPN. So therefore, your ISP will not know what you're doing anymore. Right now, they're logging likely every website you visit, every search term you enter, maybe keeping those logs for up to 5 years in some cases. You can put a stop to that tonight by going to proxpn.com/FTL, download their software. It's available for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, and Android devices, plus Linux users. You can also use ProXPN. The setup's a little bit different, though, for Linux. Easy to do, though. Go to proxpn.com/FTL, download the software, get it installed, get running. You can do that all for free. And then when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account for unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can connect to, private torrenting ability, plus you can get past regionally blocked websites with their premium account, you can upgrade and get a sweet discount for the lifetime of your account. So this discount applies for as long as you hold your account at ProXPN. The discount is 50% off the price of the annual account. You just use our discount code FTL50 when you upgrade to premium. That's FTL like Free Talk Live and the number 50. And that brings the price down to about $5 per month. Now, maybe you want to save even more. You want to pay with Bitcoin? Well, you can do that and get 62% off the annual account. Use code FTLBTC if you can pay with Bitcoin for the annual account. So you get some deep discounts on privacy that is priceless. Plus, with ProXPN, they don't keep records of your online habits at all, and there's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. You got nothing to lose but your privacy. Go and get started right now at proxpn.com/FTL. So, Mark, you've been sharing with us this story from Yahoo News about the lifted restrictions, whatever they were, on bombing innocent people in Syria and Iraq. There was a mention in the article that it's both Syria and Iraq.
That's
so,
right.
What else?
They just say Syria in the headline,
yeah,
and I think
the story.
So that's, you know, and a lot of people just read the headline. I've got to say, I admit most news stories I pass by, I just read the headline. I keep abreast of the news through headlines to some extent.
We only have so much time, you know. We don't have professional producers to do that job for us.
It still wouldn't keep me abreast of the news, even if professional, you know, if
that's
somebody
true.
Else read a story,
reading headlines.
Somebody else read the story that I just read a headline on. So, it, you know, you only have so much information in your life that you can cull through.
Do you feel like there's more in this story you want to share?
I think that there's one interesting piece here. So, there are a couple of throwaway paragraphs here. I don't think it's worth the trouble. But at least one of the House members present, Representative Adam Kinzinger, an Illinois Republican, supports stronger U.S. action in Syria. He said he was not overly concerned. I did not hear them say that there were civilian casualties, but I didn't get the details, Kinzinger said in an interview with Yahoo News. But nothing's perfect. Whatever civilian deaths resulted from the U.S. strikes are much less than the brutality of the Assad regime. And,
what?
Okay, so what business is it of yours and mine how brutal the Assad regime was to its civilians? Mm. Trust me, if everybody in Syria rose up, enough people in Syria rose up to take down Assad, they could.
Yeah.
Now, obviously he's got people on his side, but that's what democracy is, right? Like, a majority of people do whatever the hell they want to a minority of people.
Yeah, it sums it up.
Okay, fine. So I'm not saying that I like any of this stuff. I'm just saying, let's look back. We don't have to even look far. We can look inside this millennium, which is rather short, this nascent millennium that we have here. We can see what happened when the United States decided to go after a terrible despotic ruler in the one Saddam Hussein. Well, that country has been in turmoil since, and now we're dealing with ramifications from that action again. Here's a little lesson for you. Yes, Assad's bad. And, you know, whatever bombing. By the way, they're fighting ISIS in Iraq and Assad in Syria?
They're fighting Assad and ISIS in Syria, is my understanding of
it. Oh, boy. Yeah.
By arming ISIS in Syria, apparently. That's the way. See, the thing is that the United States military is so powerful that they have to give weapons to their enemies before they attack them, just to, you know, sort of even things
up. To make
up,
it fair.
Yeah, you know, I mean, they just don't want to go and, like, punch a man with glasses on or something like that. They've got to give him a rocket launcher and then blow him up with a tomahawk.
So that's it. Okay. The Republican is not that concerned about civilian deaths. I didn't hear anything about that, but I wasn't listening that closely.
Well, I don't imagine Rand Paul's very concerned either, based on some of the statements he's made recently. Now, as 2016 approaches, we're going to hear more and more about Rand Paul. Actually, as 2015 approaches, and during 2015, we'll be hearing more about him, because there are certain people within the Liberty Movement, of which all of us are a part here on Free Talk Live, who seem to think Rand Paul is a libertarian. And they are under this collective delusion to a very large extent. It gets a little bit annoying sometimes. Inevitably, people will call and attempt to convince me and others on this show that Rand Paul is a libertarian. Chris, I don't know if we've discussed Rand Paul with you on the show previously.
I think we've touched on it briefly. I mean, when we had the election here, we started talking about electoral politics in general. And I don't know if Rand Paul came up specifically, but I mean, he is... I wrote an article at one point. There was an article in the Foundation for Economic Education, FEE.org, that somebody had written Rand Paul is some sort of libertarian Frank Underwood from, like, House of Cards. I don't know if you guys ever watched.
I've never seen it. I've heard a lot of good things.
Got to check out House of Cards. One of the best things I've ever watched. But, you know, in House of Cards, Frank Underwood is this really ruthless politician. He's a crooked Democrat who basically will do anything, and he's trying to seize political power. And I don't want to give away too many spoilers, but he does incredibly screwed up things in the course of this, trying to ascend power. Yeah. And so there were people who were suggesting that Rand Paul was some sort of libertarian Frank Underwood, that he was going to do all this underhanded stuff in order to, you know, scale back the government.
My yes. favorite part about House of Cards, by the way, is the big controversy is there's this loose woman in the form of a reporter who will sleep with people to get stories. And the female reporters don't like it. So you have one character that people are complaining about, this woman who supposedly sleeps with people for stories, and I don't get
have
the impression.
Have you seen the show, or are you just saying you've heard about
it? I'm just
that?
Listening to interviews and things like that. I intend to watch the show, but I have not watched it. And so nobody complains about the Kevin Spacey character, who is a despicable human being. And every other man apparently in this are, like, despicable human beings. But the female reporter, it's like, oh, we never sleep for stories.
Yeah, how could you?
You're ruining our reputations.
Possibly portray a woman negatively on television. This
really
is misogynistic. But, you know, as long as, you know,
but
you can portray men
it.
As murderers and, you know. And look, let's face it. Like, I've had sex for worse reasons than to get a scoop on a story, folks.
Okay, so I believe these ladies that they don't do it, but what I see, I believe that everybody else, all the other underhanded stuff, does happen because nobody disputes it.
Right? It's not like politicians are lining up to say, "Hey, we would never do anything like Frank Underwood."
But they don't.
And I'm convinced that these female reporters who are so upset about having it portrayed that way are probably really upset because they're being exposed.
Toll free number 855-450-FREE. More coming up.
Talk radio generally, and Free Talk Live specifically, are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com. Majid lives in Nor Deven, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Question. Could too many GMO foods and toxins be overloading your digestive and immune systems? Answer, yes. If you're searching for a powerful detox that's gentle enough to use every day, use Pro EM1 from Terriganics.
Pro-EM1 is a powerful liquid probiotic that uses good bacteria to suppress pathogens and gently eliminate toxins from your body. A healthy digestive system will cleanse and remove toxins, support weight loss, improve absorption of food nutrients, and aid in controlling yeast and other infections. Pro-EM1 is made with only non-GMO and certified organic ingredients, has no preservatives, and is dairy, soy, wheat, and gluten-free. Pro-EM1 is the key to your digestive health. Order Pro-EM1 Daily Probiotic Cleanse at Terraganix.com, spelled TERRAGANIX.com, or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Also available through Amazon Prime. Pro-EM1 from Terraganix. Life's getting better.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, take control toll-free. We've got Skype. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, of course, you can join us online and get interactive in a variety of ways at freetalklive.com. If you like the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, then please shop with us. You can do that by going to shop.freetalklive.com. There are links to Amazon there, as well as some other shopping options. But Amazon's the primary one. There's Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, and Amazon US. You click into the right Amazon for you, and you're taken to your usual Amazon shopping experience with a huge selection of products, the amazing shipping deals, and you know everything you're used to there, all the user reviews, etc. It's just that you're entering through our affiliate link, so Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale. Very simple, makes a big difference for us when you do it. So please take that moment and go to shop.freetalklive.com. It's very much appreciated. So we're talking about Rand Paul. And the Washington Post has a story about his opinion on ISIS. There are people who seem to think Rand Paul's a libertarian. Rand Paul doesn't agree with them. He has made statements very specifically to clarify that he is not a libertarian. But yet, people within the libertarian movement still continue to believe in this conspiracy theory that Rand Paul is indeed not just a libertarian, but an anarchist who's hiding effectively among the Washington elites, just waiting for the moment where he can introduce more freedom into Washington, D.C., even though all the evidence suggests that there's no truth whatsoever to that particular conspiracy theory. And here's some more evidence for you from the Washington Post. A funny thing happened over the weekend, and this is a few weeks old. While President Obama took heat for saying he didn't have a strategy to deal with the Islamic State, I guess that's changed, in Syria, Rand Paul delivered a pretty remarkable statement. Quote, "If I were president, I would call a joint session of Congress," said Paul, and he continued to say, "I would lay out the reasoning of why ISIS is a threat to our national security and seek congressional authorization to destroy ISIS militarily." So, yeah, not a liberty-oriented statement, because a libertarian...
Well, that's a constitutionally-oriented
like
statement.
Like Ron Paul or Harry Brown or anybody else who actually has some chops as far as freedom is concerned would say, yeah, ISIS, none of our business. In point of fact, the U.S. government created them by arming, you know, various different groups over all, you know, the last several decades, and the only way to really stop the violence is to, or at least lessen the violence, especially against Americans, would be to remove the United States military from the Middle East, and not just that, but around the rest of the world, and then bring them all home, and then hopefully shut down the military. Now, most of them wouldn't say shut down the military, but at the very least, a libertarian-minded person would talk about removing the military from the Middle East. But no, Rand Paul wants to crush ISIS militarily, and there's only one way to do that.
No, he didn't say that. He said if he was the president, meaning if he was in the president's shoes, he would do what was constitutional and bring this to a vote of Congress, because all war powers
rest with
Congress.
Well, that makes him a libertarian. No, it doesn't at all.
He didn't say that that he would bring them to war. He would, if in the president's shoes, he would go to Congress, he would make his case.
Which is,
see,
which
you can read this however you want.
Which is not libertarian.
Which is not libertarian, but it's also certainly a lot better than what Barack Obama does, where he just unilaterally claims the authority to go to war with anybody he wants. So, I mean, there is, of course, I know it's lesser of two evils. I don't agree with
right,
yada,
so he's
going
to ask Congress to back his warmongering.
Wait a second.
Yes, and that's sort of important, because when you have an imperial presidency that wages war without the consent of the legislature, that's a more serious problem than a Congress declaring war.
Fair enough. I'll grant you that. Yeah. But that doesn't mean he's a libertarian, and there's all these people within the liberty movement who are just, oh, they're head over heels for I stand with Rand, as though he's somebody worth supporting. And I'm sorry, I can't get excited about somebody who's advocating for more war.
You're reading this in a particular light. He's not saying that necessarily.
How can you read it in any other light? The statement is that he would lay out his reasoning of why ISIS is a threat to our national security and seek congressional authorization to destroy ISIS militarily.
Let me restate it. Consider that politicians mince words with an intention of getting both sides to report them.
He's one of these Rand Paul supporters.
Let me restate
it. Go ahead.
So, what the president should do if the president wants to fight a war in the Middle East is he should follow the Constitution. We have a set of rules. Those set of rules should be followed. So therefore, the president should take his case to Congress. He should lay out the reasons why people of the United States are in danger from ISIS, and then a vote will be held and we'll decide constitutionally how this is done. Now, does what
the
I
Congress
said,
will decide more accurately.
Right. Well, okay. Yes. So the Congress will decide, the people, the representatives of the people will decide whether or not we should go to war. Does what I say, is that much more, is that a little softer for you? Because it's really the same words.
I don't care if you rephrase his statement, Mark. He's saying he wants to destroy ISIS militarily.
He's saying that rather explicitly, actually. No, he was saying
he's going to lay out his case and he's going to ask them to support his plan of destroying ISIS militarily.
If he was the president, he is not.
That's right.
If he was Barack Obama, who was in this situation, he doesn't know what Obama knows.
He's a likely presidential candidate, right?
Indeed. Yes.
So he's telling you that, look, when I become president, yes, which is my intention, this is how I will pursue wars with foreign monsters.
It's a better way to support to pursue wars.
It is. I agree with you there, but it's still something that it does get me irked, right? Because there are people who call themselves libertarians who say, like, hey, you know, I really like this way of waging war. And I'm like, well, no, libertarians are pretty much I don't think that you can square non-aggression and government warfare. You can't square that circle.
You could argue he's a constitutionalist, okay, but that doesn't mean he cares about peace, and that doesn't mean that he cares about liberty or freedom in any way, shape, or form.
That's not what my argument is.
Right.
Listen to my argument.
You said earlier he's supporting the Constitution. Are you saying he's not a constitutionalist?
Listen to my argument. My argument is he's saying if he was Barack Obama. Now consider,
which is what he wants to
he
be.
He doesn't have. No, he does not want to be Barack
Isn't
Obama.
Isn't he running for president?
He wants to be the 45th president of the United States. You moron!
He does. He does want to be Barack Obama. That's where he's wearing his pants halfway around his butt. And he's...
So, listen to me. What he's saying is, if the president has information that ISIS is a danger, saying. That okay,
he said, if I were president, that means if he were president, no, this is what he would do.
If I were the president,
no, it says if I were president.
Okay,
the contortions that you Rand Paul
what
supporters
contortions?
Will go through, the mental contortions you will go through to justify the things coming out of this mouth, this man's mouth, as something relating to libertarianism is so ridiculously transparent. It's pathetic.
I don't know that we can pin Mark with the Rand Paul supporter label. I mean, he's
you
got
just
a,
haven't
he's
sat
got
here
a,
long
he's
enough.
Got a, he's got a pig named Rand Paul that he intends to shoot in the head. Okay, so this would tend to indicate
he's got spots, so he's different than the rest of the pigs, but it's only skin deep.
And unlike the bullet that's going to go through his skull,
he's a good boy. He's a good
oh,
boy.
He's better than the other pigs.
Yes,
or is
that's
that
right.
The case?
He's gonna kill him last.
No, Chuck Schumer is a good pig, and so is Harry Reid. They're all good pigs.
All right, let's bring
Mitch
an
McConnell
actual Rand Paul
is
supporter.
Awful little pig.
We'll bring somebody on here who will absolutely embrace Rand Paul, I suspect, and that is the pizza dude from was it North Dakota? You're on with us.
Fargo. Time. Yes. Yeah. Reagan said that the heart of conservatism is libertarianism.
It's ridiculous.
He also said
that he was going to reduce the size of government.
Right. And George Bush said he wasn't going to nation build, and Barack Obama said he wasn't going to invade Syria.
Yeah. That's my point.
What's your point?
They said, oh, I'm a libertarian, I'm peaceful, but then they weren't. You need to judge them not based on what they say, but their actions. Rand Paul says, I am the standard bearer of reasonable intervention. That's what he says. He says, if it were in my shoes, I would lay out not my case, the case for interventionism, and he would bring it to Congress, whatever case there is. But if you look at his actual actions, because they did vote whether or not to airstrike ISIS, he kept saying, yeah, I'm in support of attacking ISIS. Yes, we need to attack ISIS and destroy them militarily. He said these things. But when it came to a vote, he got up and gave a 45-minute speech against violent interventionism and the double trading that goes on in the Middle East.
I think you're mistaken, because I don't think that there was a vote held on airstrikes. What the vote was held on was arming Syrian rebels, and that, I believe, he voted against. And correct me if I'm wrong, but my understanding is that wasn't even something that was put to the Congress, which is why Barack Obama said, I have the power to do this. He was using the same use of force authorization that was used against Afghanistan. The vote that happened in Congress that Rand Paul spoke out against was arming the quote-unquote moderate Syrian rebels, because he at least does see the folly of that you hand over weapons to these militant groups, and sure enough, they end up getting used against American troops.
But the point remains that by getting out in front of the interventionist parade and saying, hey, look at me, I'm the standard, I'm not a libertarian. Oh, no. Everything I say isn't libertarian, it's conservative. And the real reasonable conservative position is to not arm these Syrian rebels. Right,
but it's still a reasonable conservative position to drop bombs on these people and to even remove the restrictions on near certainty that you don't even have to be certain to go after these people.
Pizza Dude, hang on. We'll bring you back here in Hour 3, which is coming up next. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, October 1st, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.07 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,212 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $384. Antiwar.com reports Iraqi military supply helicopters were supposed to be taking shipments of food, water, and ammunition to besieged troops in the Shakwala base in the Anbar province late last week, where they've been out of normal supply lines for a week. The supplies were dropped, just not where you'd want them. Instead of dropping the shipments of food, water, and ammunition on the besieged base, many of the pilots mistakenly dropped the supplies on the Islamic State fighters themselves, which is great for the Islamic State, who after all is using the same US-made weaponry Iraq's own military is, largely looted from Iraqi military bases, and might have had a hard time finding spare ammunition otherwise. The bungled airdrops were reported by Iraqi Member of Parliament Hakim Al-Zamil from the Security and Defense Committee. He said the mistakes were because of lack of experience of the pilots. NBC quoted an unnamed Iraqi Brigadier General as confirming the incidents had happened, and Zamil insisted that there will be an investigation into the commanders organizing the mission. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Reuters reports the head of the U.S. Secret Service faced scathing criticism on Tuesday for the agency allowing an intruder with a knife to run into the White House, while details emerged of a separate security lapse involving an armed contractor who rode an elevator with President Barack Obama. Secret Service Director Julia Pearson acknowledged the agency charged with protecting Obama had failed on September 19th when it allowed a man to jump the fence at the home of the president, burst through the front door, and run about 130 feet into the East Room, which is used for events and receptions. Pearson told a U.S. House of Representatives committee, "This is unacceptable, and I take full responsibility." As a first step, Pearson said that the front door of the White House now has an automated lock when there is a security breach. It did not have one at the time of the intrusion. Pearson said that any disciplinary actions, however, would be based on an internal probe by the agency. In the spirit of Motorhome Diaries and Liberty on Tour, I intend to take the message of peace, love, and liberty on the road. During the 104-day trip, I'll be visiting at least 10 cities across the country, speaking to people about the ideas of peace, love, and liberty. To find out more about the tour or to donate, visit tour.fppradio.com. That's tour.fppradio.com. The Associated Press reports Oklahoma prison officials unveiled new execution procedures Tuesday to replace those used in April when an inmate writhed and moaned before being declared dead 43 minutes after his lethal injection began, a situation that renewed debate over what constitutes cruel and unusual punishment. The new guidelines allow the state to keep using midazolam, a sedative used in flawed executions earlier this year in Ohio, Oklahoma, and Arizona, although it calls for increasing by 5 times the dose it gave Clayton Lockett in April. Other changes include more training requirements for prison staff and members of the execution team, and having contingency plans in case the problem with execution equipment or an inmate's medical condition. The new protocols also reduce the number of media witnesses from 12 to 5. An investigation ordered by Governor Mary Fallon after Lockett's execution that was conducted by the Department of Public Safety blamed his lengthy death on the poor placement of a single intravenous line in his groin and a decision by the warden to cover the IV site with a sheet. The investigation recommended more training for prison staff and a contingency plan, both of which are included in the new procedures. Assistant Public Defender Dale Beach, who represents 21 death row inmates who have sued the State Department of Corrections to block their executions, said the new protocols do not solve Oklahoma's execution problems. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The couple told reporters this week that they routinely urge their son Patrick to devote all of his time and resources to his improv comedy education.
We keep telling Patrick again and again that if you don't buckle down and start learning basic concepts like yes and the Herald now, nobody is going to take you seriously later in life.
He has to start thinking about this now.
The parents explained that he should try to get as much out of his improv training as possible by attending improv jams, forming a few indie teams, and doing as much bar prov as possible to keep himself warm for those upcoming Herald auditions.
The fact is, if Patrick were on stage with his fellow improvisers, and one of them were to play, say, a supervillain who's afraid of mice, Patrick wouldn't even be able to identify the game in that scene, let alone respond in a supportive way.
I gotta say, I had this internship at a law firm, but I quit to do a character workshop and a musical elective. I think this is really gonna pay off for me in the long run.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We're here to take your calls. You may dial in toll free. Bring up anything you want with you in the studio this evening. It's Ian,
Chris,
and Mark.
Christopher Cantwell is with us from ChristopherCantwell.com. You can go there and get more of his written pieces as well as podcasts. Some Garbage Podcast is your show, Chris.
Yep, I got videos and texts and all types of wacky stuff going on at ChristopherCantwell.com. So you can go there, check that out.
You should do that. And also, our Skype username here in the studio is lrn.fm, so feel free to connect in that way if you like. In fact, we've got a couple folks that are waiting on Skype right now to talk about Rand Paul, who is purported to be some kind of hidden libertarian, that he's secretly an anarchist.
The libertarian Frank Underwood.
But that apparently he just doesn't sound like one because he's secretly trying to get into the presidential seat so he can all of a sudden make everybody more free, which of course is, you know, just ridiculous. While he may be the best of all the scumbags in Washington, D.C., that doesn't make him a libertarian. Even Rand Paul himself will tell you very crystal clear that he's not a libertarian. And there's this quote, as quoted in the Washington Post, saying that he would lay out a reasoning of why ISIS is a threat. This is if he were president. He would call a joint session of Congress, lay out the reasoning of why ISIS is a threat to our national security, and seek congressional authorization to destroy ISIS militarily. Not a libertarian position in any way, shape, or form. As Mark pointed out earlier, it is a constitutional position in that technically the president is supposed to ask permission to go and do things like warring, which is why, you know, for instance, a war hasn't actually technically happened by its legal definition since World War II. Because, you know, the presidents have not bothered to declare war and have Congress declare war.
Right. They have
Was Rand Paul a Ron Paul a libertarian?
I would say you can make a much better argument that Ron Paul was a libertarian.
But you're
not
willing
to
say yes?
Why do you ask?
I'm not willing to say yes.
Right. I mean, so like the question is how strict is your definition of libertarian?
Well, libertarians has a very strict definition. A libertarian is one who does not advocate for or support the use of force or the threat of it.
Initiatory force.
Right. The threat of force, initiatory force to achieve political or social goals.
So Ron Paul, not a libertarian.
Ron Paul is very, very libertarian, I would say.
He's libertarian leaning. And by that standard, you could say that Rand Paul is also more libertarian leaning than other people. But that's the like sliding scale theory of libertarianism. And I don't like it. I mean, this is not a dimmer switch. It's an on-off switch. And if you're advocating for initiatory force, that in my book closes you out of that realm.
There are a few issues on which I would quibble with Ron Paul, but generally I don't think Rand can hold his dad's jockstrap as far as...
I knew that would get in.
They're libertarians.
In.
Yeah, it's one of my favorites. As far as his libertarian positions. Why? Were you going to point out how unlibertarian Ron Paul was?
I'm just making the point that Ron Paul's not a libertarian either by your definition. Like, you want to say Rand Paul's not a libertarian, but you gave money to the Ron Paul campaign.
That's right, because Ron Paul was actually promoting the ideas of liberty actively during his campaign,
Paul
is not doing.
Would we say that Ron Paul, perhaps... You supported him because he supports the ideas of liberty in verbally, like he talks about them and that sort of thing. Rand Paul is trying to work within the system to win.
I don't understand your point.
I'm just making the point that you don't care whether anybody wins the presidency or not.
That's correct. As a liberty-minded person, is my goal to spread the ideas of freedom and the principles of liberty so where people can understand, can process, can embrace those ideas, and hopefully we'll see some sort of a libertarian renaissance at some point during our lifetime because of people who are effectively communicating those ideas. And what we find out is that if you are a liberty-oriented person, you can actually get elected in a place like New Hampshire. So it's not impossible to be a liberty-oriented person and not, you know, and win election. That's certainly a possibility, but I support political campaigns that put the ideas forth that I find are worthwhile, not some sort of slimy scumbag who supposedly secretly supports liberty and he's going to do it someday, but right now he just needs to tell a bunch of lies so he can get elected, which is what many of the people who support Rand Paul are saying, is that, oh, well, he's just lying like every other politician, and I can't support a liar. I mean, I'm sorry, I've got some morals and principles.
When you have mastered the art of political doublespeak as to have like John McCain fans and anti-war libertarians eating out of the same trough, okay? you're a terrible, despicable excuse for a human being. There's just no way that you can do that. And the thing is that somebody definitely gets screwed over in that equation. And my study of history leads me to believe it will be libertarians who get screwed.
Let's bring the pizza guy back on. He barely had a chance to make his point in the last portion.
He doesn't
of the
have
hour.
A point.
Go ahead, pizza guy.
Well, I really don't have much of a point other than just to support Rand Paul.
Wow.
You say that he lies.
No, I'm not saying that. That's what many of his supporters say.
I just said that like 10 times. You said
he's
a
definitely
liar.
A liar.
No, I don't know if he's lying, but many of his supporters say that he's lying.
I don't think that's the pro-Rand Paul position either, is to say that he's lying. I think it's to say that he's choosing his words extraordinarily
These
carefully.
Are the contortions I'm talking
right,
about.
Exactly. He's not lying.
Exactly,
he's just
politics.
Choosing words that lead you to believe something that isn't true.
You'd make a great politician, pizza guy.
Your problem is not with Rand Paul, it's with politicians. You just don't like the system. I mean, do you really think we could go from an Obama to a Ron Paul presidency or just an Amos presidency?
No, and nor do I care.
No, he doesn't care. This is the point that needs to be very clearly displayed, Pizza Guy, is Ian doesn't care.
I'm under no illusion that Washington, D.C. is ever going to go in a libertarian direction. I don't believe that for a moment, and I don't think anybody who can look honestly at the situation who's of a liberty or any perspective should take that perspective.
I don't know why anybody would take, especially Washington D.C. electoral politics seriously. I don't even take them seriously here in New Hampshire, but Washington D.C. based electoral right. politics are going to lead to nothing but terrifying horrors, right? Because just think about it for a second. I mean, you know, do you walk around the world and think that most of the people that you bump into are real smart? I mean, these are the voters, right? So they're not voting because they understand what they're voting for. They're voting on, you know, what they've been told is good and different feelings that they have. They have no concept of what's going on down there. They're just going there and voting based on who someone else told them to do at best.
Right, and oftentimes they're going to vote because they were told that it's the right thing to do. If you're a completely malinformed individual that pays no attention to politics at all, you should go vote.
Yeah, take into consideration that most of the people who would consider themselves like informed about politics are spending their days watching MSNBC and Fox News, okay? If that's where you're getting your information from, you are sorely misled. And if you're these are the people who consider themselves really well informed about politics. Most people
those
who are
the
voting,
people that are well informed.
Most people who are voting don't even have the concept of politics that they would get from watching one of those two mediums. So if you think that you're going to ever have a situation where somebody who means well is going to end up in office, I'm sorry to inform you that that's going to turn out terribly poorly.
Well, but I don't know which office we're referring to.
Go ahead,
in New Hampshire.
Guy.
Well, you know, it's we don't live in a vacuum. And so you were saying, you know, the informed people listen to MSNBC and Fox News, and that's where they're getting information, and that's what the problem is. Yes, but what Rand Paul affords us is an opportunity to have somebody as the Republican leader go on to Fox News and say, you know what? Maybe we shouldn't put people into jail for marijuana. Maybe we should let felons vote. He goes on to Fox News and says these kinds of things. Now, look, you can say maybe he's not principled. Maybe I hate politicians. And maybe we just need to wait for the world to end so that, you know, after the collapse, then we can have control because we'll be ready in our shacks up in the woods.
Lots of libertarians say just that.
I don't know that I've heard Rand Paul advocate for drug legalization.
No, he hasn't.
I think I've actually heard him say the exact opposite. So
no, he advocates for decriminalization over and over again. It's always
of cannabis, maybe, but not. I've never heard him advocate for anything else.
He's not going to get on stage and say heroin should be legal.
Shame
That's
on
not
him, then. Thank
happen.
You for the call it's tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Ron Paul got on stage and said that during a presidential debate, and he got applause from a standard Republican audience.
Yeah.
Why shouldn't
what
Rand Paul get
what
on
What makes it? You think, hold on, you didn't poll this audience. Ron Paul's people are dedicated. They packed that audience, and they cheered him because he's Ron Paul. They cheered him every opportunity they had. They would kill any poll that came on for president. All you had to do is put a poll on your site if you wanted to have 100,000 Ron Paul people come there and vote for it.
Or one Ron Paul supporter vote 100 times as I did in many online polls.
Back with more here in moments. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Rand Paul has no courage. It's Free Talk Live.
Hi, Chuck Woldery here. I don't know about you, but I don't like taking pills for minor arthritis pain, and I don't like those patches either. But I have found something that works, Australian Dream Arthritis Pain Relief Cream. It's a great product. It doesn't smell or burn, isn't greasy, and it works. And Australian Dream has an empty jar guarantee. You can use the whole jar, and if you're not happy, you get your money back. But I doubt you'll send it back. This stuff really works. Australian Dream is now available at Target or your favorite retail store.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Did you agree? Did you totally agree? I'll bet that you did. But did you read the agreement? There are 7 billion people on Earth, and there are over 6 billion active cell phone accounts right now. And every one of them came with an agreement. Billions have already agreed to allow entities that they do not know to use and abuse every feature of their mobile devices. Your computer activity is monitored and archived. Your car is tracked, and even your face is scanned. The current power structure grows more fearful every day of your desire for anonymity, independence, free association, freedom of movement, freedom of expression, and your freedom of thought. And entire categories of humans will be targeted. And if they, then those that won't leave us alone, determine that we are not within their control, then we will be categorized as out of control. FreedomsPhoenix.com will launch the next phase of the Levolution by the end of the summer of 2014. And if you have to tell your neighbors about it, then we did it wrong.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free. 855-450-FREE is the number. You may dial in and bring up anything that you'd like. Rand Paul is on the table at the moment. The unprincipled individual who some people seem to believe has principles, but he's just lying about them in order to, lying about not having them.
He's not lying. He's just choosing his words very carefully to lead you to believe things that are not true.
Yeah, as one of our recent callers said, or thereabouts. So you can call in about that or bring up anything you want. You can also join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com, where if you've got Bitcoin, you can contribute to the Bitcoin tip jar at bitcoin.freetalklive.com. The tip jar address is there. You can just drop in whatever amount of Bitcoin you feel is appropriate. But wait, what's that you say? You don't have Bitcoin yet? Well, maybe it's time to consider getting some, because the price is down from where it's been over the last few months. It's down around $400 per Bitcoin. Now, you can get a fraction of a Bitcoin. In fact, with ExpressCoin, you can even get less than $40 worth of Bitcoin and do it for no transfer fee.
Right. All you have to do is use coupon code FTL at ExpressCoin.com, and you can get Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, Darkcoin, whatever coin. They've got some, Blackcoin.
There's a few coins, but yeah, they don't carry them all.
They don't have them all. There's hundreds of cryptocurrencies.
It'd be crazy to carry
that would be sort of complicated.
Yeah. It'd be stupid, too. Anyway, you can, whether you're in the United States or Canada, you can do it money order, check, wire transfer, or you can make a deposit at a local credit union that has shared branching. You can have your Bitcoins within a business day if you do it that way. You can do it from your smartphone with their app from ExpressCoin.com. Just use coupon code FTL if you're going to get less than $40 just to try them out. I understand you need to try them out. So there's no fee. Coupon code FTL. Get less than $40. There's your opportunity to try them out.
Easy.
I've done lots of business with these folks, and you know, they make it, the process, easy, safe, fast, legal, inexpensive. ExpressCoin.com.
All right, we're going to continue with your calls and thoughts. We go back to Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. We have Liberty Lubber calling from the Midwest. You are on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. How you doing? Thanks for having me on.
Welcome. Go ahead.
Hey, as far as Rand Paul goes, real quick, you know, do I think Rand Paul is a libertarian? No, no way. Do I think he's anything like his dad? No, no way again. You know, was his dad a libertarian? Pretty dang close, except for the pandering to the whole pro-life crowd. I think that's bullshit.
You can't say that on the radio. We got to let you go. But thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. Some people don't realize that even though we appear on the internet, Free Talk Live is actually a radio show. We're on 160-plus radio stations at various times throughout the week, and unfortunately, we have to have a zero-tolerance rule about that. I wish we didn't. I really do, because I don't care personally about
someone. Yeah, if you want to curse on the air, come on some garbage podcast. Yeah.
Do you take calls?
I will next episode. Yeah, okay, I had to shut it down for a little while because I had a little trouble with the system, but I'm fixing it.
All right, cool. I'm sorry about that, Liberty Lover. Call back another night and tell us how you really feel.
Maybe James will give me a call.
That was the problem.
Without using the word BS. So
yeah,
shorten that down a little bit and you can get away with saying
BS. But at
BS.
Least he answered all his own questions before we had to hang up on him.
He was ready for that interview.
All right, so let's continue on here. We got Crichton in Louisville. You're on Free Talk Live. Crichton.
Hi, guys. First, I want to say, Chris, that is the largest vaporizer I have ever seen.
That's what she said.
Crichton is watching on the cam, by the way. You can go to our webcam at cam.freetalklive.com, and you, too, can observe Chris with his vaporizer.
Nothing speaks to us, a mature, well-developed adult, but that's what she said joke.
I think it definitely double as a sex toy. There's no doubt at all.
Chris may be well developed, but he's never claimed to be mature.
No, he hasn't, thank God.
Ian,
yes, sir.
Your position amounts to a purity test for libertarianism.
It does.
Yes.
Which I really don't think it's fair, especially coming from someone who does not claim himself to be a libertarian. You don't like the title. You go prefer voluntarist, but you don't want to use libertarian because
of
the
I'll accept it. I mean, I begrudgingly accept the term libertarian, but it's because of people like, you know, let's see, talk show hosts who claim to be libertarian, like Dennis Miller, for instance, which he's not at all a libertarian. I feel like these people who are not libertarian claiming to be libertarian sort of poisons the term. So I don't really, it's not the first word that I would use, but I would begrudgingly accept it.
And I like Adam Kokesh had not so long ago gone over this thing that, you know, he called himself a libertarian and was allowed to just run with that title, right? And was told that his libertarianism was just pure enough. And then he joined the military and went to Iraq, right? And he didn't feel so good about that afterwards, and he said that he's fighting for the word libertarian to, you know, have this purity test, if you will, of not the standard of non-aggression, because he doesn't appreciate that he was allowed to run with the term libertarian and then go into a war zone, you know. And I think that if you do apply that purity test, if people wanted to be counted as libertarians and you say, well, you can't be a libertarian and advocate for a militarized southern border of the United States, you can't mm-hmm. be a libertarian and advocate for foreign interventions and all of these different things. If you want to be a libertarian, you can't advocate taxes. Well, I think that you're going to educate people a lot better than sort of giving them this wishy-washy, you generally want a little bit less government in your life sort of nonsense.
Which is why Rand Paul does not like that title. He doesn't like it because it implies a purity test that he does not want to have to live up to.
Because he has no principles.
Well, he does have principles. He just has different
what are they?
Than you. Ian, one of your big issues is that you want to see that kind of purity in your public figures, but your public figures don't have purity if they run for office.
Well, that's not true. Here in New Hampshire, we've got plenty of liberty-minded people running for political office.
And you've got a lot more people who have absolutely no standards whatsoever running for office, which is why government doesn't work.
Right, so the reason I have a purity test for politicians is because I only have so much money, and I want to allocate that money to the people who are producing a message that is as close to pure as possible. So therefore, I supported Ron Paul because he was actually introducing people to the ideas of liberty in a fairly principled way. So therefore, he got my money. I gave him some money to help him promote those ideas. And I will support local candidates here in New Hampshire who support the ideas of liberty. And many of them, I have no doubt, are principled, liberty-minded folks. The president, the former president of the Free State Project is running for state rep right here in Keene, New Hampshire. I have no doubt. doubt that this guy is a principled individual, and so he's got my support. That's the reason I have a purity test, because I want to allocate money to the right people promoting the right message. Rand Paul, not that person.
Well, no, he doesn't claim to be. That's what I'm saying. You're accusing him of being disingenuous.
No, sir, I have not accused him of that.
We are accusing him of being disingenuous because he is misleading people. However,
I haven't accused him of that.
All right, what Ian was more referring to then, if I understand it correctly, was the support from people who call themselves libertarians who are trying to assign this label to Rand Paul that he's like a libertarian Frank Underwood, that he's just talking the talk so that he can get into the presidency and restore the freaking republic.
Right, so he can sneak liberty under the radar and somehow pull the wool over people's eyes. And then poof, he's going to get into office and be a libertarian. I don't believe that about him because I don't think he's a libertarian. But some libertarian people believe that about him. Crichton, thanks for the call tonight. Toll free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. To me, he just seems like another Republican who happens to be good on some issues, better than some other Republicans. Whoopie doo. Not good enough, not even close to good enough to get any kind of support from me. Certainly not a dime's worth of support from me, and I certainly will not verbally support him either. It's Free Talk Live.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Are you ready to surrender your right to buy body armor? No joke. Congress is now trying to outlaw civilian body armor. And if House Bill H.R. 5344 becomes law, you can kiss your right to protect yourself against rifle bullets goodbye. Don't put off your body armor purchase any longer. Go now to infidelbodyarmor.com. Thousands of military veterans trust their lives to Infidel Body Armor. You should too. Spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people
who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And joining you tonight, it's Ian here.
Chris.
And Mark.
Join us online over at freetalklive.com. The features we give to you, you can enjoy them all on us. Those other talk show hosts in the business, they want to charge you for their sites. Go and enjoy for free at freetalklive.com. You get to actually create the content on the site. You find something online you think's interesting, you want to share with us, just submit it as content there over at, or as what we call show prep, over at freetalklive.com. And then other listeners can vote it up or vote it down based on whether or not they like or dislike it. You can go and do that all for free at freetalklive.com. We continue on with your calls and thoughts. Let's go first. We're continuing. Lots of Skype calls coming in here, by the way. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Liberty Phoenix is on the line in Illinois. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. I had a topic, but there's not enough time in this last segment to cover it. What I really wanted to call in about was the fact that I owe Chris Cantwell, sir, I owe you an apology.
Oh, really? I'm interested to hear why you think you owe me an apology.
Well, if we as voluntarists are to hold ourselves to a higher standard, then the hypocrisy within me requires that I apologize to you for damaging your property. At Porcfest, I tagged up a bunch of your posters. And for that, I do apologize. It was immoral of me. It was a destruction of property, and it was not my stuff. And I
hang
apologize.
On a sec. All right, so this deserves some further explanation. The Porcupine Freedom Festival is a yearly event put on by the Free State Project. It's a camping festival where lots of liberty-minded folk come to enjoy themselves and the company of others and all kinds of other things. And Chris Cantwell, you did not attend this year, and I found that unfortunate, but it was because you felt unwelcome, which is what the Free State Project made some sort of statement about how you were unwelcome from Porcfest.
That's right.
Weren't they allegedly shaking down cars looking for him? I mean, yes. He's pretty unwelcome.
My argument was unwelcome doesn't say banned, but yeah, they were apparently shaking
then
down
cars. Then they eventually threatened to call the police if I showed up, what I ultimately got reported.
I thought that was unfortunate, and we have talked, I think it was probably, a year ago, just over a year ago now, that this Free State Project dust-up happened between you and the Free State Project board.
Yeah, it happened just before I launched ChristopherCantwell.com on September 1st of last year.
They didn't like something you wrote on a website, and they were upset about that. My perspective on that here on the show was that they made a mistake, that they shouldn't have kicked you out of the Free State Project, and they shouldn't have banned you from Porcfest.
My perspective is that you are a world-class marketer, and that you wisely got them, turned them around, and got all kinds of sort of liberty news from getting these folks to ban you.
So what happened as a result of this ban was you had a little bit of fun, actually probably a lot of fun, trolling Porcfest this year. So some of your supporters at Porcfest posted some posters. Did you design it, or did somebody else design the poster?
I did design the poster. So it was brought to my attention that Porcfest security was like looking for me, right? And so people started sending me text messages like, "Hey, are you here? Because I hear that Porcfest security is looking for you." And I'm like at my house.
I was one of those people who sent that.
Like a couple hundred miles away or something, in my underwear watching Netflix. Like I have no idea what he's talking about. And I kept on getting different reports from people about this. So yeah, what I ended up doing was I posted a meme to Facebook with my cartoon character and a wanted poster, like report sightings on VHF, whatever it was, their Porcfest security channel. And so it got a lot of attention on Facebook when I posted the meme, so I ended up having like 100 flyers printed up with that poster and sent them up to some supporters there.
And I went around and I tagged up a bunch of them.
Was it funny?
What did you tag it with?
It was... to the effect of not wanted for podcasts. It was for drunk driving. And it's a low blow, and I apologize for that.
It was a low blow, but your apology is nonetheless accepted, of course, and I appreciate you reaching out to do that. And, you know, the thing with the Free State Project, you know, they've spun different stories. If they had actually banned me for drinking and driving, it would have made sense to do that after the actual drinking and driving incident happened in 2012, instead of having me back in 2013 when I did not have a drop to drink and was 60 days sober when I showed up and had at the time all but given up alcohol. Then when they have another different political disagreement with me, then they start trying to switch it around and say that it was because of drunk driving when they had very clearly stated that it was because of this article. What they wanted to do was make me retract statements. And so when I made them look like fools, they decided to just go on full-on character assassination mode on me and say any nasty thing they could, from drunk driving all the way up to he's a federal agent. And this is ridiculous.
Technically,
well, I really think that the crux of the reason for my call is not only to apologize, but to also highlight the need for anyone who is going to label themselves as a voluntarist, as a libertarian, as an anarchist, as whatever individual you want to be, as a porcupine, to truly personalize the sense of hypocrisy, which I believe
was... What is hypocrisy? It's the second time you've used that term. I've never heard it.
It was a term that I noticed in Mr. Divey Barker's book, Authoritarian Sociopathy, where there was a study, and in the study, they questioned these individuals about, for them to relate, to remember a time where they felt that they had power, but they felt that that power was illegitimate, and they would divulge into a state of hypocrisy as opposed to hypocrisy, where you don't hold yourself to the standards that you hold others to. Hypocrisy is the opposite of that, where you hold yourself to a higher standard than you hold everyone else to. And I think that that's going to be what's required for a free society to flourish globally, that is. And I really wanted to highlight that need for everyone that is going to don the badge, the shiny badge of voluntarism or anarchism, that you have to get yourself in a mindset of hypocrisy. Hold yourself to a higher standard than you hold others. Do not lower yourself to the shady dealings of statists.
Yeah, I think there's a real temptation to lower yourself to the level of many of the critics, and it's tempting, but I always recommend, hey, don't do that. Like, for instance, here, the Stop Free Keen folks, there's always a temptation to use their same tactics, and I try to stay away from that personally. So you were apologizing to Chris out of the idea that you wanted to hold yourself to a higher standard.
Yeah, I felt bad about it because if I'm going to don that tag, I should, you know.
Now, technically, let's bring this up as a property rights issue because it's my my perspective here is that if you're going to post pieces of paper, wanted posters around a campsite, couldn't you argue that that's abandoned property at that point? That it's not being...
I would.
Really, yeah, so therefore, I don't think that it was really graffiti or anything.
I mean,
like
there was an incident previously, and the funny thing is that some people then accused me of littering for other people putting these flyers up, right? So they said I was violating the property rights of Rogers Campground by posting these things around, or the property rights of the Free State Project who had contracted with Rogers, whatever. So people had accused me of littering for
as
doing this.
As though you were there doing right. it, right?
And so what? But at the same time, now we have a story, I believe, from the year prior that there was some vendor at Porcfest which was like making noise at night. And so people were discouraging people from using their services or buying their food or whatever it was by putting up flyers, right? And then what I'm told is that the vendor actually said, hey, we'll give you $1 off if you bring us one of these flyers.
Brilliant.
And so this, in my mind anyway, and it's an interesting theoretical conversation, but in my mind it's like, yeah, you put the thing up. Look, people are going to, you know, take
they
it
do
down
what they
right
do.
On it. You know, it's you're putting a piece of paper on a tree that, you know, doesn't theoretically belong to you. Am I littering by advertising? Well, you know, other people advertise at Porcfest doing similar tactics, and they're not accused of littering.
Didn't do it on the same scale, and that's kind of one of the questions here. I think that if a post is a handbill is tacked up, that's what this is, posting of bills. A posted bill is up. It then becomes
a potential medium for art.
It's the commons at that point.
Yeah, and I don't think that what you did would be bad or wrong or anything like that. I really don't. I mean, you know, you expressed an opinion.
I wouldn't personally consider that art, though, Mark. There was a malicious intent behind it.
Yeah, I mean, what you went to do was to say something nasty about somebody, and I mean, that was obviously your intention, and it wasn't about... I saw exactly what you wrote when you said for drunk driving. I actually saw somebody post the picture, and I said, you know, this wasn't even, like, done well. He just sort of scribbled it on there over the bark of the tree, and it really looked terrible. But, you know, I get what you were doing. I wouldn't have held it against you to begin with, but I appreciate you making the apology.
Thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate that. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We have enough time for you with your thoughts. Get on the lines now or call in via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. It's Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro-Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at herbalhealer.com. As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988. Herbal Healer Academy.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
35% of U.S. credit accounts are facing collection agencies. Of that 35, almost 40% are the result of medical bills. Before uninsured friends or family go in for medical treatment, send them to AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com. No computer tracing, no tracking cookies. They will not go on a list. Privacy matters. Just tell us what you need. Get a quote. Fractions of U.S. prices. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Talk Live. Moments remain here, but just enough time for you with your call and thoughts. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And of course, you can join us online at freetalklive.com. Keenvention is coming up. We are 1 month away from the second annual Keenvention. It happened for the first time last year, and it was a lot of fun last year. A very intimate convention as compared to many conventions where hundreds of people will attend. We'll be lucky if we have 100 at Keenvention, and that's actually a good thing. I wouldn't mind seeing it grow to 150 or something like that. But if it gets too big, then it gets more impersonal. It gets hard to meet everybody. And that's one of the nice things about Keenvention is you get to meet everybody there because it's so small. And you'll get to meet many of the Liberty activists that you hear on this show and also talked about on this show. We've been announcing over the last several months various different panel discussions and keynote speakers that we're going to be having at Keenvention. You can go see all of that over at keenvention.info. Just early this morning, I posted the official schedule. It's technically subject to change, but it should be mostly nailed down at this point. So if you want to have some idea of what's happening on what day, October 31st through November 2nd, that schedule is now available at keenvention.info. Of course, we're doing things inside the hotel. We've got social events happening inside and outside the hotel. There's all kinds of fun stuff going on. The very first Halloween costume party will be happening. Derek J came up with that name, I think, and he's kind of putting together, along with a group of other activists, they're throwing this wonderful, what will hopefully be a very wonderful, fun costume party, at which Chris Cantwell will be appearing and possibly speaking with a comedy set.
Yes, I will be there, and I think we confirmed me for the media panel as well. I'll be on there. If you are thinking about going to New York City October 11th to see me at Liberty Fest NYC, I will not be there. People were tagging me about this on Facebook today. I will not be at Liberty Fest NYC. If you were thinking about going there, skip it. Come to Keenvention or do both.
Back. Yeah, tag them back. Hit them with keenvention.info. There's going to be a lot going on throughout the weekend. We got a movie premiere this year. That did not happen last year. We've actually cleared out Saturday morning for the theatrical premiere of the 101 Reasons That Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, so I'm excited about that. Of course, the costume party Friday night, various different panel discussions, for everything from the legislative panel, which will be all about, you know, how accessible the legislature is here in New Hampshire compared to other places and how you can make a difference whether or not you're elected as a state rep, whether you're just somebody who wants to go there and testify. So we've got Mark Warden, who's the two-time Liberty Legislator of the Year. He's going to be heading that panel up. I just announced the other panel participants, which include an Activist of the Year, Keith Carlson, as well as Kevin Bloom, who is one of the Liberty lobbyists there in Concord. So you're going to hear from the experts. These are the people who really know their stuff. And so from everything from legislative activism to civil disobedience, to direct action, we're going to cover a lot of different topics. It's going to be a good time. So go to keenvention.info. Tickets are just $60 for the entire weekend, and you can also pay with Bitcoin. So go to keenvention.info. You can check out videos from last year, watch the full panels, watch full speeches, and it's all of the video content is free at keenvention.info. But we look forward to seeing you in real life as we continue here with your calls and your thoughts. Let's go to first James in Arizona. You're on Free Talk Live, James.
Yeah, when you meet non-believers, smite their necks. And whoever, speaking of ISIS, that is a follower of Baghdadi, the Caliph, they call him, they believe that that means to chop their heads, their non-believer enemies' heads off. And even people that are non-violent people, so such as you people. But speaking of initiating force and fraud, ISIS is big time up to it. And to shoot them and drop bombs on them is a Christian thing to do.
Ridiculous.
Well, I'm not going to disagree that, you know, killing people from another religion is a Christian thing to do. I mean, that's happened enough times, I think, right?
What about the Prince of Peace? What about forgiveness?
I don't call ISIS a religious Muslims, by the way, I never use that word about ISIS. You guys always do, and you think I'm assuming I'm talking about Muslims. I'm talking about the Islamic Free State Project that uses guns and ammo to make their little dream, Liberdopia, come true. And they don't care about you, nor do they. They're glad that you're over in the Keene in New Hampshire preaching against their enemies. That would be the U.S. military. They take comfort from that. And speaking of all the things you say about people that would put their sassafras on the line to defend another person's right to live free with liberty and pursuit
of
happiness.
Are you talking about the military?
It doesn't even happen to be, that happens to be brown and happens to live in Iraq and Syria.
Are you talking about the military? How does Japan play into this? That's what the audience is dying to know.
Oh, that's so funny, Christopher.
I chuckled.
Opinions are like Cantwell, and that she
everybody has them. Thanks for the call. Toll free number 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. To suggest that the U.S. military is defending freedom in any way, shape, or form is so ridiculous. They're defending the politicians.
It's not their job to defend freedom around the world. It's their job to defend freedom of U.S. citizens. And I would really
know. It's their job to do what they're told by their political masters in Washington, D.C.
Fine. I think that the story that we're told is that they're defending the freedom of U.S. citizens.
Great. And go arrest some cops then.
I would be really interested in knowing, tell me the stories that occurred since 1950 of U.S. people in the U.S. military that have really defended freedom for people in the United States. Because what it seems like is that they were put on, their lives were put in danger. Their lives and sacred honor were put on the line there for the whims of politicians in Washington, D.C. that, many of their friends died for whatever it was that was going on in Vietnam. I mean, I don't know, but that seemed like a big waste of time. Most of this stuff just seems like wastes of time. The politicians don't have what it takes to win wars. Sadly, why are they sending people out to die then?
I don't know. Generally, when it comes to government warfare, I don't know that there are winners, right? Like, you go in there and you say, okay, look, we're going to play who can kill the most people, and the guy who kills the most people wins.
And then
what happens is you win ISIS. Yeah. What you win is the Islamic State. Then you go and you take out the Islamic State and you get another bigger
group
problem.
Of killers.
Yeah.
There you go.
Hey, I got some good news. A little bit of good news. Since you mentioned the Netflix series with, what was it called again?
House of Cards.
House of Cards, which has been like this big deal because House of Cards was kind of their first thing, right? Wasn't that their first series?
I don't believe it was their first original series, but it was probably the biggest hit.
It
was one of the best video productions I've ever seen in my entire life, and it aired exclusively on Netflix.
Right, and they released the entire season all at once.
Wait. When they let it go, you could just watch the entire thing and whatever. 12-13 hours,
as they call it,
which I did.
So Netflix is
repeatedly
they've changed television as a result of that, or they are changing sort of the way television is thought of by people, and they've become a major player and a competitor with these big networks who are producing content as well because they're producing original shows now. Well, there's interesting news here from it's all over the place. In this case, it's VentureBeat.com. about how Netflix and the Weinstein Company are now going to be releasing the sequel to Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon simultaneously on Netflix the same day as it's released in movie theaters.
Interesting.
I just saw the headline as you had it there, and I was really excited just to see that headline, because especially they're working directly with the Weinstein Company. They are huge in the movie industry, of course. So if they're teaming up with them to release movies the same day that they're released in theaters, you're going to that's a major game changer.
That is a
huge
disruption in the delivery of movies. And I know that there are probably some very upset theater owners right now who, for the longest time, this is the first time this has ever happened.
Yeah.
For the longest time, the theater guys had first dibs, right? They would have the movie for several weeks. And what we did see happening was, after a movie was done with its theatrical run, is that it would be released sooner and sooner. Like, over the last decade, it seems like the time frame that it would take to end the theatrical run to DVD was shrinking. it would, like these days, it seems like a DVD will come out just a couple weeks after a theatrical run almost. It seems like that.
It doesn't take long.
I think that you can thank like the Pirate Bay and piracy in general for that in large part, because of course people were getting the DVDs from bootleggers, you know, well prior to them being released in the stores. And a lot of people would just as soon walk into the store and buy the DVD as get it from the shady guy in front of the bodega. So I think that this is
it's a game changer.
Now, have you read the article yet? Does it say, I mean, are they going to introduce a pay-per-view thing for this, or this is just going to be part of your Netflix streaming subscription?
As I understand it, it's going to be part of the deal.
That is huge. Yeah. That is amazing.
I don't know for sure on that, but
it's going to kill theaters.
Well, maybe it will, maybe it won't. I mean, there's a lot of people who said that, you know, VCRs were going to kill the movie business, too. Right. I don't know.
I think there's still a lot of room in the marketplace to go see it in the theater on the big
with
screen.
A big
have your bucket
sound,
of popcorn, and you can leave it on the floor, and you don't have to clean up
after
yourself.
See you tomorrow. FreeTalkLive.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, October 1st, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.07 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,212 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $384. Antiwar.com reports Iraqi military supply helicopters were supposed to be taking shipments of food, water, and ammunition to besieged troops in the Shakwala base in the Anbar province late last week, where they've been out of normal supply lines for a week. The supplies were dropped, just not where you'd want them. Instead of dropping the shipments of food, water, and ammunition on the besieged base, many of the pilots mistakenly dropped the supplies on the Islamic State fighters themselves, which is great for the Islamic State, who after all is using the same US-made weaponry Iraq's own military is, largely looted from Iraqi military bases, and might have had a hard time finding spare ammunition otherwise. The bungled airdrops were reported by Iraqi Member of Parliament Hakim Al-Zamil from the Security and Defense Committee. He said the mistakes were because of lack of experience of the pilots. NBC quoted an unnamed Iraqi Brigadier General as confirming the incidents had happened, and Zamil and